if this doesn't make you want to throw up.
For failure.
The most annoying thing on two legs.
What a bore fest.
Who cares about the funny? Just bring me the porn.
Aren't we dumb? Hee hee.
Oh, do you want to play?
Anthony. I will beat children about the head.
Jim Norton.
I'm dancing. I'm a naked whore.
It's indescribable. I'm trying.
It's like a rape that's covered by insurance.
Ah!
Some of the comments they make are uncalled for.
Ah! Ah!
Why are you crying? The virus finally hit him. Well, with Jimmy, you never know. It could be AIDS.
No.
Yes, yes.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. The virus that spreads from town to town across the U.S. of A.
I hate you.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Thud, thud, thud. I love that drum. Thud, thud, thud.
I used to love this intro music.
Yeah.
Now I just realize why so dramatic. Why so dramatic?
Everything's so dramatic. Wow, this is the music that says we're on.
You're on the air. Alert, everybody. The Opie and Anthony Show is about to broadcast.
Alert.
Good morning. Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show.
Self-important.
I see a bunch of pal talkers just waking up for their day.
That's it.
Good morning, pal talkers.
I got to get the E-Rock cam up. There we go. Isn't it weigh-in day for him later?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think the bit's over, though.
I think he lost a little weight. You can see it in his face or something.
He's also wearing black. That makes you look thinner. He knows what he's doing. He's all over this one. He's not going to be made the fool. Yeah, we'll weigh him later, though. It's the ONA virus spreading across America. Our phone number is 1-866-313-FREE. That's 1-866-313-FREE. It is kind of cool to check out Pal Talk because you can tell people are setting their alarms to start their day with the Opie and Anthony Show.
Yeah.
They're all right now just stretching and getting their morning coffee and...
Oh, and morning cigarette. Jesus.
A morning cigarette. You get to see the first glimpse of nudity. Wow, my voice just changed like I'm 15 years old.
Can I point out how great it is that poor Eric loses a little weight and you go, all right, bit over. He's actually starting to look good again.
Huh? Oh, it stinks.
Yeah, why give him acknowledgement of that? Just
we're not doing the bit to try to help him with his plight. We're praying that he's gaining weight. Loses weight, who cares? The fun is in the fact that he steps on the scale and he gained a pound or two, and then we just point and laugh at him.
Yeah. Then he lost some weight and bit over.
Yeah, we got lots to do. We really do.
Whoa.
You want to start with the front page of the paper?
Yeah, sure. That annoys me.
Well,
we were talking about how this annoys us, and then we realized we were annoyed at the opposite ends of the spectrum on this one.
Yeah, but then people are going to think I'm, like, real liberal or something, but that's not what I'm getting at. Basically, the front page of the New York Post is there's a hoity-toity antique shop.
Yes. Carl Kemp and Associates Limited Antiques.
On the Upper East Side, a place that I would never hang out in.
Dude, it's called Antiques. Did you say Antiques?
I'm just heading the idiot off at the pass that writes that one in.
So it's a hoity-toity. You go in there and you pay $2,000 for something that some dead person used to own.
Lampshade made of skin, perhaps. Some type of antique.
And it's on the Upper East Side, which is just the area of New
York
City.
I am Carl Kemp.
And what's his name?
Zell. White Angel.
Carl Kemp.
Yeah, Carl Kemp.
Carl Kemp.
Antiques. He owns an antique store in the very, very rich Upper East Side neighborhood, I guess.
Yeah, and well, here's the deal. Like I said, it's a hoity-toity shop. People go in there and they spend a ridiculous amount of money on crap, old crap. And they're doing the story on the news right now. So,
unfortunately for him, they show the front of the store, gold lettering, Carl Kemp Antiques, huge picture window that shows the goods inside, And unfortunately for him, centered right on his picture window is a grate in the street. You see it there?
Yeah.
On the sidewalk.
Yeah.
And out of these grates usually pour heat. And where there's heat, you will find the homeless.
Well, they got to keep warm.
They try to keep warm over these grates that go down to the subway or wherever, a Con Ed access. And there's a homeless guy.
And obviously the homeless guy has been hanging out there every night for a really long time.
They stake their claim, these homeless people in New York City. They have it like territorial. They're very territorial. They get a spot that's good, and they stay there until someone bigger and badder kicks them out of there, and then, you know, that person gets a spot. It's the law of the jungle out there.
Yeah, we've learned all this because we know more about the homeless than Mayor Menino!
Oh, we know everything about the homeless. I know for a fact that they smell very bad. I just know this through experience.
Right. By the way, Mayor Menino counted the homeless. Has he done anything else since then? Of course, we're talking about the mayor in Boston that had a big, huge problem with our homeless shopping spree.
Yeah, we took the homeless out shopping for Christmas.
We're going to be counting the homeless.
On a day where we count the homeless, they are taking them to a store and buying them things.
All right, now what? Ooh. Now what? You counted the homeless. Now what? Now what? Now what? Now what do you do?
They are counted.
So anyway,
on this day that you count the homeless, I hope you count masculine homeless.
Big tongue jerk. I'd like to put a garrot around his neck. Or garrot.
And remind me... remind me to talk about Ron Valeri, our old friend.
Why even bother?
Up there in Boston, showing his true colors. What a dick. Yeah, keep supporting Mantown.
Exactly.
And see where that gets you. What a dick. Oh, we got a little mission for the pests.
Oh, yeah, hey.
Sounds like a little paranoia. Our ratings are going up, 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 up in Boston, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I'll be completely honest, Mantown's still kind of beating us here and there.
They have a little bit, just a tad bit of a head start on us, let's say. How many years? About 15?
something like that, yeah.
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 A little bit of a head start.
And, you know, to the Boston listeners, you want to listen to the Mantown show, there's nothing we could do. There's nothing we could do. It's an awful, awful radio show.
Mm-hmm.
Ron Valeri knows it. So the latest ratings come out, and they're beating us in some demos. So Ron Valeri is all excited. He sends out a mass email to pretty much everybody that's ever worked in radio ever, 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 ever.
Uh-huh.
And then at the end of the emails, just bragging about his stupid morning show beating us still in some demos. Mm-hmm. It smells of paranoia. It smells of paranoia.
Keep your eyes open. We're right behind you.
And he knows it. He tried to hire us. The guy tried to hire us. He was the first guy.
Didn't he?
That, well, no, I'm
At
talking.
At one point?
Well, he did hire us back in the day.
Yeah.
When we moved out to Boston. But when we were on just satellite radio, he was the first guy that came our way trying to hire us to work again at AAF. And do afternoon. Oh, no, it was going to be mornings. That's right.
They were going to boot.
They were going to boot the Hillman.
Mantown. They were going to boot him out and put us in there and I guess give them, you know, afternoons. I don't know. But, that didn't happen. We were contractually not allowed to do that at the time. And now he's bashing us.
Yeah, so Ron Valeri, who used to be a friend, he's now an enemy of the show.
Enemy of the show.
To the O&A Pest, why don't you call the Hillman this morning and just ask him politely, is it true that... Ron Valeri tried to hire Opie and Anthony to take your slot in mornings.
Right.
And see if he's going to be honest with you today. So Ron Valeri sends out this mass email and it just smells of paranoia. Smells of paranoia.
Reeks.
We're right behind you, buddy. We're right behind you.
Oh, I don't want to be behind Mantown.
Better there than in front of him bent over.
That's true.
If we can't,
good point, sir. Good point.
If we can't beat a radio show that their biggest bid is Mantown, you know what? Time to retire.
You can hang out and just be men because you're so whipped.
Time to retire.
You got
to
find a closet.
If we can't take care of this, they do Looney Tunes Tuesday. Ugh! Looney Tunes Tuesday!
I'd sooner have a water drinking contest.
No kidding.
Lose my job that way.
But anyway, Ron, got your email. It's kind of sad that your true colors are coming out, you dick. And you want to play? We're going to play in the coming weeks and months. Trust me on that. Trust me on that. And your email just smelled of paranoia. And why don't you go tell Hillman that, yes, you did give me a call and said, I would like to hire you and Anthony. How do we make this work? We want to bring you back to WAF to do mornings.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you go march down the hall and tell Hillman that is true, because that's going to create a little friction between you two.
I don't think he'll do that.
Of course,
even though
not.
You're asking.
Well, the listeners will be calling up to Hillman today and ask you. You guys ask him, and get a hold of Ron Valeri and ask him. Yeah. Want to be honest? You want to be sending out these emails to everybody? Well, let's play then.
Send him emails.
Now we start playing.
Call him.
Anyway. Backing up to the homeless situation. So this guy, Carl Kemp, in his antique shop up there on the Upper East Side. Yeah, like Ann said, a grate that keeps the homeless warm. A guy, I guess he's been hanging out. That's his spot.
Yeah.
His little piece of New York.
That's
this
it.
Grate in front of this hoity-toity antique shop.
And before you start wondering what type of homeless guy this isn't the type that people like.
This isn't the type of
homeless guy that is... he was working, had his family, and through losing his job and health benefits, he lost this, ended up in a shelter. And this guy is a lunatic.
Look at his face.
He's a crazy person.
He's adorable.
Adorable.
He looks like he can play Santa Claus.
Dude,
who are you kidding?
He looks like Tippy Tom. He's the third Tippy Tom we've seen so far.
He looks like a cleaner Tippy Tom. He looks like you put a red suit on, he could play Santa Claus at Macy's.
No.
Yes, look at him. Look into those eyes. I'll show you creepy, scary homeless guys. Just come to my apartment at 4 in the morning.
Well, you know something? If he was sane and a sweet guy, maybe he wouldn't have this quote in the paper.
All right.
Let me get my...
Is this a real quote?
This is a real quote.
All right. Go ahead.
Now, if he was sane, he might have been able to... explain himself and say, you know, why he was homeless and why he's here, and maybe garner a little sympathy with people. But when asked about this situation, he said, "Leave me the alone." He grumbled, "I don't want to be involved."
All right. So,
and later,
the
same man walked up to Kemp's store window after closing at about 6:20 and placed two bags of miscellaneous garbage on either side of the warm grate. He got down in the fetal position and did not respond to further questioning. He's crazy. He's one of these crazy New York homeless guys, and apparently, Carl Kemp is upset with this. So he's decided to take a unique little tack in this whole thing.
And finally, we get to the punchline here. This guy, Carl Kemp, is suing the homeless guy, for $1 million.
Suing him for $1 million for driving customers. He says the whole thing is because he drives customers away. Customers don't want to visit his store.
Not true.
Because they're intimidated.
Not true.
Or the bad smell coming off the homeless
Not
guy.
Not true. It's so not true.
How is it not true?
Because you live in New York, this is just part of what it is. You're walking by homeless people all the time. They're sleeping in front of stores. You step over them to go into nice restaurants. All this is going on in New York City all the time.
Well,
you live in New York, you're used to this.
And he's suing for $1 million, knowing that, you know, this guy, this homeless guy, ain't going to be able to defend against a $1 million lawsuit.
And you're taking the side of Carl Kemp.
I just think that the Giuliani tried to do this years ago. They're crazy people roaming the streets. They're not. There's different types of homeless, and people are mistaking these hard luck stories, people down on their luck, with the lunatic homeless. This guy is lunatic homeless. This is a guy that perhaps will just take a cobblestone and smash someone on the back of the head someday for no apparent reason. It's a crazy person.
Yeah.
So you've commented
in the past about homeless people outside your window keeping you awake when you used to sleep in the bedroom.
Yeah, for the new listeners, I'm not an advocate of the homeless. I you know, if I see a homeless person, if I'm in a good mood, I'll give a few dollars. But I'm not, like, chasing down homeless people to try to take care of them or give them money every single time. Some people, I basically look at them and go, get lost, get a job. I am like that as well. And other times, I'll give money. It just depends on my mood that day. But, yes, homeless guys sleep right outside my apartment.
Yeah, and you said when you used to sleep in that room upstairs instead of downstairs in the rat basement.
Right, right.
You said you heard them rummaging through the garbage, getting in fights.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it kept you up.
Well,
it was
Kenny,
annoying.
Club Soda Kenny sees the homeless guy because he warns me every morning. He's like, he's out there today. And he lays down a mattress and everything.
Isn't it annoying?
I just kind of walk past him, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
He's kind of creepy because he's a black, older homeless guy that wears women's lingerie.
Oh, the story turns sexy. He wears women's lingerie?
Yeah.
It has been warm.
And for some bizarre reason, even though he's right outside my apartment, he doesn't really bother me. So I'm like, whatever.
No.
I don't care.
Yeah, till one day.
Huh?
Till one day.
Yeah, but
that's,
I guess,
all it takes.
I guess this homeless guy is leaving bodily functions behind.
Yeah, he's like doing his business in front of the guy. The guy's homeless, yet he has made this little space, this open-air space in front of Carl Kemp's Antiques, his home. And his home must include a bathroom. So he uses the sidewalk in front of the place
but
as a bathroom.
But Carl Kemp doesn't own the sidewalk in front of his joint, does he?
Yeah, but I believe, you know, when the guy relieves himself in the little vestibule doorway there, that's probably a problem. People go and... You take a little sniff when you walk in, and it smells like the subway, and you got it.
So you have no problem with this ass suing the homeless guy for $1 million?
No, I think it's a unique, original solution.
But this is what I hate about New York, these snobs. These snobs who think they're better than everybody else.
You know, the Kemp family may have come to this country years ago with nothing but the change in their pocket when they came to Ellis Island. And they've built this little empire, little antique store in a nice neighborhood. Shouldn't he have the freedom to run a business without a stinky homeless man taking dumps in front of his
Well, in the article,
place of business?
He says that he calls the police. The police come by. They remove the homeless guy.
Yeah.
And then, unfortunately, the homeless guy comes back 10 minutes later. So if you're Carl Kemp, just keep calling the police over and over again. And then, you know what? The police will do something.
Now, the police...
But to sue this guy for $1 million is just ridiculous. And I think one of our listeners should go down there and take a dump in front of Carl Kemp's store.
Oh, no. I'll tell you what the police do. You call the police and keep calling them to take the homeless away? The police get mad at you. I've been on some ride-alongs. The police get mad at the person making the call 20 times to do the same thing, to remove the homeless guy. So they finally say, look, there's nothing we can do about this, and if you make a call again, I'm going to take you in.
Well, I hope the homeless...
And that was almost verbatim.
Well, I hope the homeless get together, and now you get five or six guys sleeping in front of this store every night.
Oh, you think they might organize?
I hope so.
How about you organize with some 2x4s and a hammer and make a house, you lazy bastards?
They don't want a house. They're happy.
They don't.
Some of these guys
They're
are
crazy.
Happy living on the streets.
They're
We've learned that,
too. Not happy. They're crazy. And if there was a single moment of clarity, they would... realize that they just don't want to be in the situation they're in.
So, Jimmy, where are you at?
I kind of agree with both of you. You're both right.
Oh,
like,
thanks. Middle of the road ass.
Dude, but it's like he's right that there are snooty people like this Kemp guy who is an ass. And then again, I just think it's kind of funny that like there's an old man. He's old, and he's in front of an antique store, and we're like, beat it, bum. This lamp is more important than you are.
Yeah, see?
The sad truth.
See, Jimmy lives in New York.
Is.
He understands. There's so many of these snobs in this city. Ugh!
How is it
who
snobby to want to run a business?
Who think their crap doesn't stink?
No, but the homeless guys does, and that's the problem.
True.
How is it snobby to want to run a business
Dude,
without
the snobby,
having
hold
that?
Hold on. The snobby part, I get it. that, you know, maybe, you know, this is hurting business to a point and that something has to be done. I get that part.
Mm.
But the snobby part is having the nerve to actually sue a homeless guy for $1 million.
The final recourse, I think. It's his last little thing that he could think of. It's like, what am I going to do? I can't sue the guy. Oh, wait.
As he jumps in his Mercedes and goes back to his really nice freaking...
I earned that Mercedes!
Whatever. Let's say...
I don't know about Carl Kemp, but I don't know if his money was given to him or he earned it.
Let's say hi to Rob on Long Island. Rob, what's up?
Yeah, by the way, that Kemp lives near Anthony, but when this bum starts pissing up F.H. Riley's front door, how are you going to feel then?
All right, there you go. How about F.H. Riley's in Huntington, right there on Main Street?
By the way, it's a fine restaurant.
Of course it
owned
is.
Owned by myself and my brothers.
Right.
400 New York Avenue in the heart of Huntington. The drinks will be flowing on Friday and Saturday night.
Of course.
You see me in there, I will buy you a drink.
And nary a homeless to be found out in front.
So what's
although
this?
You might think they are because a lot of pests go down there.
Right. Yeah, man, you guys are wrecking the business. Could you dress a little nicer, please? We're trying to sell some meals in there. If there was a homeless guy in front of F.H. Riley's, I would kick him in the head.
You have to get rid of him.
Throw ice water on him.
Now, I don't know if this guy has a personal vendetta against this homeless guy or if he truly is in some way, shape, or form through his excrement chasing away business.
Right.
But, you know, as a business owner, if there was a homeless person and you felt he was interfering with your business,
right,
and there was nothing you could really do about it, I think you'd probably be a little pissed at him. Could be.
No, I don't know. I don't know. I can't imagine that it's actually hurting business. It's more of a nuisance for this guy personally.
Mm.
San Francisco has the worst homeless problem.
Oh, well, they're very liberal.
They're so liberal that it's getting the best of them. There's homeless people outside all these really nice restaurants. And people, I've watched them. That's why I said this earlier. They actually step over these really... really down and out homeless guys to get into these fancy restaurants.
When you're a city that really caters to and takes care of the homeless, you are destined to become a destination for the homeless. When I say take care of the homeless, again, I don't mean taking care of the family man that was down on his luck or the single mother who's got kids and is in a shelter and had a job and that really wants to pull herself out of that. It's a different story. Those people can be helped and should be helped because eventually they'll be productive members of society. These people are mental patients. It is like you open the door to Bellevue or any other mental institution in any big city and let the craziest of crazy people out on the street.
Well, they actually did that.
That's what they are.
They closed down a lot of those facilities,
and
those people ended up on the streets.
Those are homeless people, too. They have the same label, homeless, as the person that's in a shelter trying to get their life together. But they are two completely different things. And this type of homeless, I really don't have much sympathy for.
This guy, he's not hurting anyone. He's not going to hurt a soul, this guy.
How do you know? These guys out of nowhere push people in front of subway trains. Out of nowhere, they pick up a cobblestone or a Belgian block and clobber some dumb tourist over the head. You've seen it happen. It doesn't happen a lot. I'm not saying it's an epidemic, but it's this type of crazy person that does it.
All right. We got to take a break. We got lots to do, by the way. We have in our possession audio.
Oh, yeah.
From the Hold Your Wii for a Wii contest. We've been talking about this for the last few days.
This is fantastic. It's telling. It's haunting. It's like a... it's grotesque almost to listen to.
I haven't heard it.
We have actual audio of the woman that ended up dying.
Foreshadowing is going on during it.
From this radio contest in Sacramento.
Brutal. When you know, obviously you know what happened. They had a contest. People drank a lot of water to win a Wii. You got to hold your Wii for a Wii was the name of the contest. And a woman died of apparent water intoxication. They're still doing autopsies and stuff. But, you listen to this audio and you knowing what happened, everything they're saying is like, oh God, that's brutal. Oh no. Oh, you shouldn't have said that. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, you knew this. Oh, someone called and said that. So it's really painful.
And what about Carter and Fester?
I don't see what they had to do with it. Justice for Carter and Fester.
All right. Very good. Apparently, for the new listeners, the Opie and Anthony show, you got to listen a little longer than most radio shows.
Linger longer.
You got to linger longer because we start all sorts of subjects and stories, and we go back to this story. We start a new one, then we go back to the, you know.
We're going to do a contest where people drink water. Drink water. And then we drag them behind trucks. Hello?
Hey, what?
It's on. I'm fired. 10 people fired.
All right, so we got that.
Greasy.
We got that audio. We'll play very, very soon.
Her brain's not bone dry. Bone dry. Swelled up.
It is haunting audio. Haunting. In honor of the homeless guy who's being sued for $1 million, let's play Grey Wolf. This is one of our homeless friends.
Someone that pulled himself up by his bootstraps, by his moccasin straps.
Well, he was definitely very homeless when he wrote this little song for his homeless friend, no. Tippy Tom. Off the cuff, he came out, came up with this on the spot. This is called Shelter Me on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Let's see how this comes out. All right.
They're right there. All right, here we go. I got to break.
This is nice. About a man, and he always was so lonely at night, but his voice was rowdy, you could hear it all through his train station, and I'm gonna sing this one. This is about Tippy Toe Tommy.
Let's go while we're young, while we're young, while
we're young. Late at night, and I have no fear to go. Money's gone and off go all my friends. And the cop says to me, hey, you smell bad, get out of here. And he says, and you know I have an angel. And he says, that angel, shelter me from the falling rain.
Don't you have homes?
This is my life.
Everyone else is talking about ONA Uncut and Live, continuing the show on XM Satellite Radio starting at 9 a.m. Eastern. Visit xmradio.com to subscribe.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. The virus is spreading.
You're We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Good morning. Thanks for checking us out today. We got instant feedback. You go to opieandanthony.com. There's a little thing you could click on. Comment about what we're talking about on the show. And some of your comments make the air. And what the hell? We'll give some airtime to Carl from New Jersey.
Carl.
One of my many haters, by the way.
Oh.
Opie, don't try to sympathize with what homeless people have to go through, a-hole. You're the dick that stomped on that homeless dude's cake and thought it was the funniest thing ever.
What?
You're a effing douchebag. Do I have to explain that again? Yeah, I did think it was funny. I laughed my ass off. These guys laughed their asses off.
Andrew is amongst the luckiest homeless around. He's a blithering idiot that he didn't show up for the homeless shopping spree. But when crowds of 50 people at a clip walk past him, when
every
we do the walk, and throw at least $5, $10, and a lot of people throw 20s in his cup, he's getting a day's, probably a week's worth of homeless guy begging money in 5 minutes.
Is it safe to say that he was getting about $100 a day
at
the
least.
Height of his popularity with this radio show?
At least.
See, he wasn't just some homeless guy on the street, Carl.
I'm pouring gas on him and lighting him on fire, you dick.
He became part of our show.
Yeah.
And he was paid handsomely as far as a homeless guy goes.
Handsomely.
For it. He got more money than some of the guys that work for us, matter of fact.
The squishing of his cake was of entertainment value, and it was paid for. Don't worry about him so much, Carl.
By the way, the video's up on YouTube.
Oh, yeah, check it out. It's disgusting and
throw Kickstop Opie and Anthony into the search and enjoy the hilarity.
Is there another cake stomp?
I don't know. You never know with YouTube, though.
Maybe that's it. Maybe it's confused.
Can you imagine
the guy steps on a homeless guy's cake and...
Can you imagine there's 100 of them out there? I'm like, damn, I thought I was being original.
What the hell?
All right. Really fast. Listen to this. It's all about Obama. We all know it's all about Obama. Yes.
All right.
Get on the Obama train, will you?
I can't.
Why?
Because it ain't going to happen. It's a useless vote. It is a useless vote. And again, if I have to vote Republican because the Democrats can't come up with a real non-comedy ticket, I'll vote Republican again.
What if Obama had an entire white staff?
Who are they?
See, he has an entire black staff, and I think that's what's going to hurt him a little bit as well. Because you got to warm up Whitey a little bit to the idea that we might have a black president.
He better start warming up middle America.
What is it going to
take? Be a problem.
We discussed this yesterday. What is it going to take?
A white man. A white man that is kind of middle of the road, not liberal, not a crazy liberal, not a crazy conservative, but a Democrat that isn't completely liberal on everything, that follows that Democratic friggin' line right down there, just like the Republicans follow that stupid conservative line on everything. You can't make up your own mind on individual issues. You got to buy the whole ticket. Enough. So if, you know, there's some guy like that, yeah, he'll be voted in.
Well, he was on Larry King recently.
Yeah.
And by the way, it's this clip's not about Obama.
No.
Larry King asks Obama a question.
Uh-huh.
It's the question or the statement that Larry King makes that is very interesting. I was just singing in a little Obama talk.
Of course.
Doesn't mean crap to it as far as what we're about to play here.
I do have the answer, by the way, for the type of black man that would win presidency. It's not an all-black staff, but he should be forced to address all white people the way Morgan Freeman addressed Jessica Tandy in Driving Miss Daisy. With that same reverence and love.
That could help. I don't think his middle name of Hussein helps either, to tell you the truth. I know what's in a name. A rose by any other name. By any other. You can't have the name Hussein in this day and age and become president.
Why?
We can't have a president where the name Hussein comes into play.
Why couldn't Barack Obama be a candidate for the 1984 presidency? Why did it have to be this one with Osama still out there?
Osama bin Laden's out there, so his name
Obama,
sounds like Osama.
Saddam Hussein.
His middle name is Hussein.
Who the hell am I voting for?
It's ridiculous. His last name should be Hitler.
Yeah.
Pete Hitler.
Pete Hitler would win.
And we all know. This guy. And we all know, including the people listening to us right now, that America in general is filled with a bunch of dummies. They're going to get very confused, and they're going to really believe that they're voting for Osama.
Osama bin Laden Hussein is running for what? I'm not pulling that lever. It probably releases anthrax.
Right. All right, listen to this from Larry King. Just another classic soundbite from Larry King.
Then we will be with them
That's
as
Obama.
Partners, but this is not something in which we can simply impose a military solution.
President Kennedy wants congressional consent for this troop increase. You support that?
Well, my office is looking at a variety of options to place some conditions on the president's actions.
Who? President Kennedy. Did he refer to President Bush as President Kennedy?
Yeah, and unfortunately, Obama didn't even...
Obama should have picked up on it.
Didn't even
Larry,
pause. Didn't
you
even pause.
Doddering old fool.
It's time to retire.
President Kennedy, what do you think about his troop increase in the NAM? Larry.
Larry, hello. It's 2007.
2007, Larry. What are you talking about?
The New Deal. Are you for it or against it? What about it? The New Deal. That Woody Wilson, he's a madman. Obama, your comments.
Right. Obama, how do you feel about the Whig Party? You think you can hold them off in this upcoming election?
Sarah, connect me to Chicago. We have a caller. Let me climb the telephone pole and talk to him. We have another call coming in over the humming wires.
Stupid Larry King. President Kennedy.
Obama, what's going to be done with all that land now that we've made the Louisiana Purchase? Got a good deal on that from what I hear.
Right.
President Kennedy.
Do you think you could win all 32 states?
What a dope.
He was off by one party and 45 years. An ass.
Let's go to a Western Union from Bill in Texas. Larry, stop. What do you think about the railroads meeting coast to coast? Stop. Golden Spike, a waste of money? What do you think, Obama?
Wow.
Remember to post your letters to Larry King so the Pony Express could pick it up and deliver it to me.
We were writing that one down. Ben had that one for you. Someone is writing on the instant feedback. Big Duties Jay, he's a faithful listener from Jersey. Holy ass, Larry King can speak with the dead.
Yeah, that's what he's doing.
I was speaking with President Lincoln the other day.
But why President?
You know, he needs this crap like he needs a hole in the head.
But why President Kennedy?
What slip up was that?
How do you slip that bad?
It's not even in the ballpark. Ain't even a ballpark.
You want to hear that again real fast?
Yeah, I got to hear it.
All right.
Okay. How naturally he says it and doesn't even realize he said it.
Obama didn't realize. Or maybe he did and he didn't.
And he just being polite. Don't be polite. Point him out.
That's probably it. He was being polite. He knew what he meant.
Yeah.
But, man, I mean, you and I would just be like,
oh.
What?
It's like you meant six presidents later or something like that?
Yeah.
This is not something in which we can simply impose a military solution.
President Kennedy wants congressional consent for this troop increase. You support that?
Well, so matter of fact.
Oh, my God. Wait, Obama. Sad news just in. He's been shot in Dallas. Oh, my goodness. Kennedy's been shot.
What a tool.
Obama, do you get cable in that cave? He doesn't even know who he's talking to.
Obama.
Maybe he meant Senator Kennedy? Uh-oh.
He
said President Kennedy, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, he said
President Kennedy.
I just started heating up like, oh, boy, we're gonna be looked like idiots.
No, he screwed up.
President Kennedy, well.
All right. Well, that's just a little quickie. And, of course, if we're talking about Larry King, we got to just play this really fast. It's a quickie, but it's one of our faves of all time.
Ladies and gentlemen, here they come at the Palladium in Los Angeles. They're back together, their first live get-together in 5 years. The Motley Crue.
The Motley Crue are back.
I didn't even know they were gone.
The Motley Crue.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Benny Goodman. We got a phone call here from Mr. Jack Ruby. Jack Ruby, you're on. Oh, no.
The Motley Crue. And then, this is a good one, too. We haven't played in a while. Roseanne Barr explains the internet to Larry King. I still call her Roseanne Barr, by the way.
Yeah. The internet as a political medium, viable?
Yeah, it's like the only one left.
Idiot.
Absolutely, and that's not just me saying it. That's everybody saying it.
But there's 80 billion things on it.
Yeah, but if you know where to look, you know, it all can come together. When you're looking for the particular information that you're looking for, after you do the big search, this is what I found out by going on there. It just takes your mind, and then you live in there forever. You can never come out.
Never gone searching.
Oh, my God. It opens up the whole universe. It's so awesome. You would love it. No, anything you want to know.
The wife loves it. I wouldn't love it. Where do you punch all the little buttons and things?
You just click on this thing. You've got to be able to read. So you have to have strong glasses when you're over 50. And then you just scroll down and click.
Scroll?
It's not that hard. I can show you how to do it.
Like the Dead Sea Scrolls? I'll be reading those tomorrow. They're relevant.
How are you on CNN every night?
What is the internet? You push some buttons and pull levers. It sounds like an episode of Lost in Space.
Right.
What is he talking about? You push buttons and levers, and I hear these tapes go spinning and spinning.
How does he get his job done without using the internet?
Flashing lights and blooping sounds.
It's the internet. You get information. It's the information you can pull off the internet is better than any you can get anywhere, as long as, like Roseanne was saying, you know where to look,
right,
how to decipher the real stuff from the bull crap, and then kind of you can form your own opinion based on a lot of other people's input. And shouldn't he know about that? Not even if he could say, no, I don't use it. I know about it. I've tried. I've used it. But
I don't want to push buttons.
Yeah, he's scared of the internet.
Ah, frightened of it. Someone sent me something once, and it looked like a car commercial. So I watched it, and then a scary face went, ah! And I had my volume up loud, and I refused to open another one of those emails.
I haven't slept since.
By the way, those scare the crap out of me. I'm a sap for those things. Oh, do I hate those?
I was in my office, and it said, cute kittens.
So I turned it up real loud.
And I love kittens. So
back in the day, as Ted Turner was walking through.
Right. So I turned up the volume because it said, turn up the volume, you're going to see some cute kittens.
And they were adorable.
They really were.
Right up until the loud volume started yelling, the boss is the C word.
The boss is the C word.
And I didn't know
the
how to turn it off.
The C word. One of my favorites of all time, by the way.
You know, we'll be talking about the internet and Rutherford B. Hayes tomorrow on my show.
Ever since I saw Tub Girl.
Tub Girl.
I haven't turned my computer on.
You push buttons. My wife loves it. I know, she was talking about something called horse gag the other day. She just watches it over and over. Whenever I come over to take a look, though, she closes something. I can't see it.
Horse gag.
Oh, what an idiot. How could you be in media? I don't care how old you are. Stop it, old people. Especially in the media. This guy should be internet savvy.
Just for this show alone, I try to read about 10 papers, you know, all the basics like Chicago Sun-Times. I get into the Philly papers, the Boston papers, the Washington papers, the New York papers. I could go on Cleveland, Dallas. All within a half hour, I could read about 10 papers because it's on the internet. What is he? He's got to get all those papers delivered and thumb through it trying to find
stuff.
Not only
that, yeah, you got to go through all kinds of garbage in the newspapers, too, to get to the juicy stories. There are many websites you could go to that just list, you know, a bunch of the top stories, the interesting things that people want to talk about, things like that. He knows nothing of this.
Right. Oof. The Motley Crue. All right, let's say hi to Greg on Long Island. A lot of calls coming from Long Island today. We love seeing that.
Hey there, Greg.
What's up, Greg?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Larry King just got to be ease up on him. He's just a little confused because both presidents don't have a brain in their head.
Both presidents. Yes.
Your call had potential, man, but you just didn't have any confidence.
Why?
Oh, I get it, because
Kennedy had
no brain because it was shot out of his head.
And Bush seems to have no brain.
He's okay, silly.
All right, Greg.
That's okay. Right. We'll let you slide.
My favorite part of that Larry King Motley Crue intro, I love the fact he calls them the Motley Crue, but I also love the fact that it's their first get-together.
Get-together.
Get-together. Larry, you know what these guys used to do?
Playing a concerto for you. A get-together.
They used to bang broads and then take tacos and do, and let's just say wash so they wouldn't get caught for, you know, cheating by the women they were going out with at the time.
They would wash themselves with burritos and tacos and Mexican food.
Right.
that was available around the corner from the house they all lived in.
Get together. These guys used to, like, do heroin together.
Yeah. You know, one of them died with a needle in his arm and was brought back to life.
Right.
Get together. A little coffee clutch.
Steven S. from Bayshore. Larry wants to know what's with that lonely girl 15.
Now, I do dig her on the YouTube.
She's adorable.
It would be great if we found out Larry was an internet predator. Larry King, you've come to this house for sex.
Hi, it's LK1065. How are you? 13. Here are some pictures of me. I know how to send pictures nude.
Maybe that's why he's going on a show claiming he has no clue about
the
internet.
I know nothing about this, and please don't look at my hard drive. Loaded with pictures of that cute Dakota Fanning. I've got mail. I know what that means. Oh, boy, they're coming in. We'll trade pics of same. Oh, whoa, whoa. There's a house in the suburbs. You want me to come over and visit? Bring some Zima and condoms? Okay, I'm in. See you there. I'm 28 years old. I know you. You're Chris Hansen from Dateline. What are you doing here? I'm banging this broad.
You won't believe who came into our house next. Larry King.
He thought we were having a get-together.
All right, Chris, you know, the whole thing. We work like the cops, you know, that blue wall. Don't say anything, okay? I'm leaving now.
You're free to go.
Get on the floor! Get on the floor! Oh, no! The Keystone cops are after me. Maybe if I run, they'll run in fast motion and I could give them a slip. That's it. Hey, sweetie, you want some garlic? Here, drink some of this Welch's grape juice. I spiked it with vodka. Just let me finish my cookie, Chris, and iced tea that the young lady poured me before you arrest me.
By the way, everyone's saying that he meant... Senator Kennedy. Ah, whatever. You got 20 minutes of hilarity because of that.
I don't care if he meant senator. He said president.
Yeah.
Guy's a jackass.
I was hoping he got the president wrong, too, but all right, whatever. When we return, and by the way, I've been saying for days that we would be dragged into the story. The first article coming from the Mercury News, famous radio stunts gone bad.
Of course.
And we're under the category of death and churches.
Oof.
We'll get into that. Of course, we're talking about the Hold Your Wee for a Wee contest that the Morning
Tragic.
Rave did. We got the actual audio of the contest, and I'm telling you right now, We are playing it next. I know at this point you don't believe me anymore, but I'm telling you, we will play it next.
Is this the clip where the radio show says aliens landed? I heard that made quite a stir the other day.
We will play the audio from the actual contest that killed a listener next on the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. The Opie and Anthony virus.
We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Festivities.
What is this? I like it.
Yeah, this is pretty cool. I don't know. I'll find out. Other things people are talking about this morning, Lindsay Lohan goes into rehab, whatever.
And this was after, well, we had talked about crap like this, where the celebrity publicists always say it's exhaustion. She's like the poster girl for that. The publicist saying, it was exhaustion. No, she'd been working very hard. There were rumors in the paper a couple of weeks back that she was drinking cranberry juice or something at a bar. and they saw her pouring some clear liquid out of a flask into the cranberry juice.
Right, right, right.
And her publicist, again, was like, no, 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 she's, you know, on the straight and narrow. She's not drinking. She's not doing anything. And then all of a sudden, boom, they're in rehab. What happened?
Yeah, they just are. They're professional liars, most of these publicists.
Yeah.
By the way, we got to send flowers to somebody. Remind me, we got to talk about that later.
A publicist?
we got to make good on something big time because of Jay Moore. We'll get into it a little later this morning, but Jay Moore really, really effed us over bad. I don't think he really meant to.
No, he didn't mean to. He was being
going for a little shock, and it's hurt us to this day.
He was being Jay.
And I think we might have to have the pest do a nice mission, a really nice mission,
all right.
Which is very rare for
Impossible.
The ONA pest. I know it's rare. I understand the mentality of the ONA pest, but every once in a while they do the right thing, and I think we might ask them to do a nice mission. A nice mission.
Have the cobra help the mongoose, is what you're saying. It can't be done.
We'll get into it a little later because we promised the audio from the morning rave. Also, cancer on the run. Deaths from dreaded disease fall second year in a row. Just people are smoking less, they're saying.
Because murder's up. Not a comedy
but smoking
thing. Just commenting. Murder's up.
Yeah.
Killing people that might have gotten cancer.
but smoking is down as far as older people go, but I think it's making a comeback with the youth.
Do you?
Of America, yeah.
What
man.
Do the studies say? Are you just saying that because you have a microphone?
It's the Greg Opie Hughes study.
Let me tell you another show that was doing a study and blurting out what they thought were facts.
Yeah.
The morning rave.
True. All right, let's get into the morning rave. You want to explain this once again, Anthony, for the people that maybe are listening to us for the first time?
Under a rock?
Yeah.
This is a show in Sacramento called The Morning Rave. They were on a station called The End, and they had a contest. Win a Wii. Hold your Wii for a Wii. It was one of these things where a bunch of contestants came in. They had to drink a lot of water.
Cheers.
And hold it. They weren't able to use the restroom. And the person that could hold it for the longest won a Wii, one of the very popular gaming systems. So sounds innocent enough until you realize that people die from this, water intoxication. It just throws off your body chemistry so badly that your brain cells start swelling and you die.
I hear it's a really tough thing to do, though. Every once in a while you get a fraternity guy dropping, but...
I think it really depends on your size. It's like alcohol. It depends on your size, your what you have in your body. Did you eat? Do you have enough sodium in your body? Enough electrolytes? In your body at the time? Were you fasting to make more room for the water? So now you're defenses are down as far as having the right chemicals in your body at that time. And it sounds like maybe that's what happened to her. So she drank a bunch of water. She died.
Mm-hmm.
10 heads rolled over there at the station.
10 people got fired.
The whole show got fired. Production staff, the producers got fired. And, my God, Carter and Fester.
Poor Carter and Fester.
Poor Carter and Fester.
They're
who,
not
by
even
the way,
part of the morning.
I don't even know who they are. But I love their names.
I think they're another show on the station, or were another show on the station.
If we ever, ever have to change our radio names, Opie, Carter and Fester, we're just stealing those names.
Oh, because Opie and Anthony is just the coolest thing. Ugh, I hate my name.
Carter and Fester.
It's a nickname I got when I was 12, by the way.
Yeah.
And Anthony and I didn't get together and go, wow, here's a great radio name.
No.
But I'm stuck with it now that I'm 32.
To have your bank account, I wouldn't care if they called it the Edie Amin and Anthony Show.
I like Edie. Did you see Last King of Scotland?
No, I was
gave
watching
it to you yesterday.
I was watching the English versions of The Office last night. Very funny. Laughing my ass off.
Hey, can we get the website for the morning rave? I want to see what the number one song is today. Yesterday it was How to Save a Life by The Fray.
Well, because of what happened, obviously they weren't taking their own warnings, and now there's audio of the show that this woman died doing, and the jocks, there's a lot of foreshadowing, a lot of things that said, and in hindsight you look back and go, oh boy, maybe you shouldn't have said that or done that, or there was this warning and that, like warnings were coming in Callers were calling with warnings about this.
So it's almost like when I listen to the St. Pat's audio.
Yep.
I'll think like, oh God, don't go to the farm.
Yeah, here it comes.
Oh,
yeah,
no. True.
You hope it'll change at some point and you'll wake up and things will be okay.
Hey, I'm on the ENDS website out there in Sacramento, and they have a section called What's Hot?
What's Hot?
Well, we know what's hot as far as your station goes. And then the last 10 songs played, they just got to stop.
No,
they just
got to
stop. Number five, Where'd You Go?
Where'd You Go?
You can't write better stuff than this. Number four, This Is How We Do It. Number three, My Love by Justin Timberlake.
Oh.
Number two, Blurry by Puddle of Mud.
Justin Timberlake inadvertently involved in this.
Oh, really?
Yeah, listen to the audio.
All right. Number two is Blurry by Puddle of Mud. And, well, number one is Call Me When You're Sober. So maybe they should just get rid of that section of their website for a while. Let's say hi to Steve in New York City. Steve.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
What's up?
Well, you know, I thought it was interesting. I had heard on the internet the radio.
The what? You heard on the what?
Exactly. You know, one of the callers had called and said, you know, this might be a bad thing. You could have water intoxication and you can die. And both radio hosts laughed hysterically.
Well, they kind of blew it off and didn't pay attention to it. But Sacramento County Sheriff John McGinnis assigned two homicide detectives Wednesday to investigate the apparent water intoxication death of this woman. So they might be brought up on manslaughter charges. Oh. Wednesday morning, the time slot that had been filled by the morning rave was taken by disc jockey known as Chris Kay, who usually does the afternoon shift. You know, that's a bittersweet thing.
Yeah.
He jumped right in there. Yeah, I'm the new morning guy.
Chris Kay with you
in the mornings. Going to be playing a lot of music because they don't want me to do anything.
They don't even want me talking.
They don't want me saying it.
Actually, I'm a robot programmed by the PD.
Won't say a word. As the investigation ramps up, McGinnis said detectives will explore whether charges are merited for involuntary manslaughter due to failure to render aid. Yeah, you'll hear a little about that on the tape, too, where you think, like, well, maybe at some point they should have, could have. But again, hindsight, you don't know.
You don't think someone's going to die from it.
It's as I was reading some of this and listening to the audio last night at home, I was thinking, Jesus Christ, you know, you're just going into work to do a dopey show and manslaughter charges. All of a sudden you have to worry that you might end up. You know, I doubt they're going to go through this and end up in jail. I really do. But just that whole thing of having to go through that, you know, you're just at work one day having a goofy radio show.
Especially that show.
That show.
It sounds goofy.
Whoa, everybody. Whoa, hey, how you doing? What? 10 years? What? But we were just doing a gag. What happened? Your Honor, what? Like, how the hell does it go from that, you're having all kinds of fun, to they're investigating you on murder charges?
They have to feel like they've been hit with a sledgehammer.
Oh,
you got no job. You could go to jail.
Bad enough to just get fired. We know that. Just to get fired is bad enough.
And we've been talking to one of the Morning Rave people, and we're getting close. We might get him on our show.
I'd love to have that.
We're getting close.
On.
We're getting close. We'll see what happens. We really want to know exactly what went on in that studio that day.
And a lot of people bring up the fact that they do sign waivers when they do this, but that doesn't necessarily protect you. You can't have somebody sign a waiver and then you shoot them in the head, let's say, and say, hey, they signed a waiver, so I'm fine.
All right. Want to get into this now?
Yes.
All right. So here's the audio from the morning rave. They're getting ready to do their, you know, hold your Wii for a Wii contest. The first track, no one's shown up yet. Fester will be drinking with the contestants.
Yeah.
So he was part of the contest as the goof factor.
He's the goofy guy.
Is he a fat
involved
guy?
Oh, yeah. Fester's fat. Of course he is. He's Fester.
Yeah. Is he their stunt boy?
Could be.
Every wacky morning show has to have stunt boy.
Fester's a mystery.
He's a mystery.
I don't know much about Fester. I want to learn more about Fester. And Carter, no clue about him.
And by the way, Carter and Fester weren't the guys that were actually on the morning rave. They were just helping out the morning rave.
Yeah.
Because you had Trish the Dish. You had Manny,
Manny, I think.
And Lucas?
Lucas.
All right.
So Fester will be drinking with the contestants. The hole makes a joke about dying of water intoxication.
Yeah, this is really creepy to listen to, knowing what happened.
All right.
Has anybody showed up yet for the contest?
Should be arrested for the radio voices.
What?
They should be arrested for the radio voices.
Wow, bring them in. Wow.
Has anybody showed up yet for the contest?
I'm not sure.
We told them to be here by 6 a.m. Right. And then at 6 a.m., we're going to rally them all together. Starting at 6:15, they're going to start their drinking their water.
Yes, the water's here. Fester's here. He's going to drink with them.
Oh, good. Fester, did you drink?
There's Fester at the webcam.
How much water do you think you can drink before you have to wee? Well, we're going to be drinking
I did 2 gallons.
Two gallons?
Oh, dude.
Can't you get water poisoning and, like, die? Water.
Your body is 98%.
Wait, what?
She said, can't you get water poisoning and die?
That was Trish.
Trish the Dish kind of knew.
Trish does not go to jail.
No, Trish should go to jail because she's the one that knew and should have known you don't you could die from it.
And she is an expert because she has a microphone in front of her.
Of course. I'll wait till you hear some of the expert lines that come out just because they have microphones in front of them.
Right.
Wait.
Gallons? Oh, dude.
Can't you get water poisoning and, like, die?
Water.
I can't believe that was said. I'm hearing this for the first time, by the way.
Yeah, me too.
And that is exactly what happened.
Wow. Wow.
Oh, dude.
Can't you get water poisoning and, like, die?
Water.
Your body is 98% water. Why can't you take in as much water as you want?
I don't know.
Because that poor kid in college.
I know.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, well, he was doing other things.
Maybe we should have researched this.
I don't know. I think what they were touching on.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, they were touching on one of those fraternity hazings where a kid died from water intoxication, and they kind of brought that up and said, well, he was doing other things.
Drinking.
Yeah, drinking water.
Right, right.
Yes, and dying.
And dying, yes, of course.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, this is really interesting.
A little eerie.
I know.
I was thinking.
Yeah, well, he was doing other things.
Maybe we should have researched this.
I don't
know.
I mean, yeah, we never do this before I start doing something. Well, next thing you know, I break out in hives. I'm in an ambulance.
If it gets dangerous for somebody, their body will automatically throw it up. And if you throw up the water, you're out of the contest.
Ah, he knows.
All right, well, there you go.
See, Dr. Maney or Dr. Fester? Dr. Carter? Which doctor was that?
I have a feeling that they saw the baby bird video, by the way.
Really?
I have a feeling we're indirectly involved with this. Absolutely. With him saying, you know, if you puke the water up, you're out. Kind of like our eggnog drinking contest. I don't want to do a hoo-hoo here. Tell him,
I invented a vomiting.
But I have a feeling, because our baby bird video was just viewed by millions and millions of people. That went viral all over the world. I'm starting to think that we're indirectly involved with this.
I'm glad.
Just indirectly.
I'm glad that's never happened with one of our wonderful contests that we've had where people have had to consume stuff. That eggnog thing. Mm-hmm. People have brought that up.
Yeah.
It drank a lot of eggnog.
Yeah.
But throwing it up, I guess, what saved them? Or can you get the same thing from eggnog as you can from water?
I don't know. We don't do any research.
Stuff in eggnog?
I don't know.
Again, we don't do any research like that.
I don't know.
Jesus.
All right, listen, we have to take a break. That's the beginning, though.
All right, you won't be hearing any more of that.
What? No.
Let's go on to... What?
No.
I thought you were teasing. Sorry.
I'm not teasing.
Like the good old days.
Look at the time. Do we have to break or not? We have to break.
Of course we do.
We have another 5 tracks to go. But there you go. There's the taste.
Gets creepy.
That's the beginning of the contest. They're waiting for the contestants to show up. They basically brought to the table that don't people die from this?
And you get to hear the actual dead woman speak. Well, you know,
that's a little
beforehand.
Creepy. That's a little creepy.
Yeah, it is really kind of creepy. She sounds very fun, energetic.
Really?
Yeah, right up until her last appearance. The last segment, she kind of sounds a little like...
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. All right.
Maybe they...
Can we hurry up through this break? We got to get right back to this.
Hospital.
We'll get right back to this after the break. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey, what's up? This is Bill Burr. Just letting you know I'm going to be at the Improv in Washington,
D.C., District of Columbia, January 18th through the 21st. You can call 202-296-7008 for tickets or go to improvclubs.com. Thank you.
Relax. Get busy with the facts. No zodiacs or almanacs.
All right. Now we got plenty of time. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. The ONA virus spreading across America. Why don't you explain what's going on, Pal Talk, this morning, Anthony?
Well, everyone's waking up. Waking up with the Opie and Anthony Show. Wonderful.
This is a very interactive radio show to the new listeners. Very interactive. We got Pal Talk cameras in the studio. We got, what, two in here?
Yeah, we got two in here. And
what happened to the office cam? Because people kind of enjoyed that as well.
Yeah, I don't know what happened to that.
And the Pal Talk cameras are on, and the audio's on, so you can kind of hear what we're doing while you guys are listening to commercials on the radio.
Yeah, we carry on our discussions, have fun, watch other people's cameras, or one other person's camera, yeah. Depending on what's happening at any given moment.
Baby girl this morning.
Yeah, baby girl this morning has been very entertaining. Just decided I'm just going to be naked in bed. Giving little shows, and then Jimmy asked to see her hiney. He actually used the word hiney, and she showed her hiney.
She certainly did.
Then she's smoking away.
Oh yeah, she loves smoking cigarettes.
There's a lot of other things going on, but we got to keep it friendly over here. All right, Morning Rave Audio. So where were we? We just played the first clip of this fine morning show that's no longer going to be heard ever again.
The Morning Rave, yeah. And they're gearing up for the big contest that wound up allegedly killing a woman from water intoxication. And they're discussing the dangers. And they're not quite sure of it. One of the jocks seems to think he has the information that you would throw up before you die of anything. Like, wouldn't that mean you could take as much poison as you wanted? You could drink, like, Drano, but as long as you throw up, you're okay?
You would not throw up from drinking water. There's nothing in water to make you
people would throw up just from... Some people do. Your stomach can't take that much being in it. So you throw it up. But once you start absorbing it, it's over, Johnny.
Okay. Well, we're up to the next track. Caller calls in to tell the show that the contestants can die.
Yeah.
There were a lot of signs.
Forewarning.
Even the hosts were, like, wondering if someone could die. I heard you could die from this. Die. And then one of them just said, nah, I don't think that's possible.
Nah, you throw up first.
Let's move on. Caller calls up, goes, look, you could die from this. The hosts already know that. More jokes about dying. Oh, here we go from the Morning Rave. Doing the Hold Your Wee for a Wee contest.
Eva?
All right, enough with the music in the background.
Shut up.
They do that at AAF. You got to talk over music because what you have to say is not important. That's what that says. And yes, we had to do that back in the day. We weren't happy about it, and we thank God, moved on.
Eva?
Yes.
What do you want to say?
I want to say that that those people that are drinking all that water can get sick and possibly die from water intoxication.
Yeah, we're aware of that. We're aware of that.
Yeah, they sign releases, so we're not responsible. It's okay.
And if they get to the point where they have to throw up, then they're going to throw up and they're out of the contest before they die. So that's good, right?
Oh, that's mean. I suppose so.
Yeah.
Did you hear the hole?
How come you guys...
Huh?
Did you hear the hole?
Oh, that's mean. Oh, gosh, guys. The hole is just doing what holes do.
Now.
Guys. Oh, you killed her, guys. Now, come on.
That's mean.
That is mean.
That's good, right?
Oh, that's mean. I suppose so.
Yeah. All right. How come you guys didn't do it?
Thanks for looking out, though.
We don't want to die.
Oh, okay. Let me ask Carter if anybody's dying.
We ain't dying.
Hey, Carter, is anybody dying in there?
We got a guy just about to die.
Oh, good. Make sure you sign that release. I like that we laugh at that. Yeah.
Holy crap.
Yeah, we got a guy that's about to die.
Oh, my God. The signs were everywhere.
I guarantee you, none of these people involved in this show can listen to this. They cannot. I have not brought themselves to be able to listen to this
yet. No, of course not.
Because it's just... The foreshadowing is creepy.
Although the criminal action now, they might have to go, what did I say that could get me in jail? Like this, they might have listened to this out of necessity. Like, did I say anything that get me thrown in jail?
Like, they're kind of showing knowledge of this. Now, with my limited knowledge of the law, I would think this hurts them more than helps them because this takes away the pleading ignorance factor. Like, we had no idea that water could be dangerous to anybody. We had no warnings or anything. Obviously, they had some warnings, and instead of heeding them, decided to laugh them off.
So not only are they so fired, I'm starting to think they're so guilty now.
So in jail?
Not just guilty, so guilty.
Oh.
Want to hear the next track?
Ow! Oh, look at me. My dumper hurts. Been in prison for a day.
Bill from Waterford, I love it. They sign releases, so we'll be okay. That's hilarious.
Yeah, you'll be okay.
All right, here we go. The host talked to the last two contestants, including Jennifer. So now, what you're about to hear, the contest has been going on for a while. They're getting close to 2 gallons of water. Jennifer, you're going to hear her voice for the first time here. She ended up dying after she left the studio a mere hours later. But this is beyond creepy, this next clip.
Carter.
Yeah.
It's down to two people.
Yes.
Let's talk to the final two people.
Okay, hang on a sec.
Yes.
Come over here, ladies.
We'll try to entice them with
yes,
this.
I got something big.
Yeah. All right. Two women left.
It's two chicks. Hang on a sec.
All right.
There you go.
Hello.
Hi, who's this?
Jennifer.
Who?
Oh, my God, I can't listen to this.
Jennifer, you know, the dead girl.
She sounds kind of
cute. She sounds cute.
Yeah.
But she's not.
She's back from the dead. It's creepy.
Did you hear the whole two go, ha, 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 two women left.
Two women left, ha, ha.
Ha, ha.
See, the girls can do it. Ugh. You go, girl. I mean, go.
Hello.
Die.
Hi, who's this?
Jennifer.
Who?
Jennifer.
Jennifer?
Yeah.
Congratulations on making it to the final two.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I don't have to go pee, but my stomach is, like, really, really full.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it all the way back up to your neck?
It looks like I'm pregnant again. It's pretty funny. I'm kind of entertained.
How much longer do you think you could go, Jennifer?
As long as my stomach will continue to let me. I don't know.
10
maybe
hours.
A couple more.
Yeah, she had about 10 hours left in her life at this
amazing?
Point.
Amazing? She had 10 hours left to live.
Oof.
We're listening to someone that ends up dying. That's creepy.
Yeah.
Let's talk to a lawyer. We got Jonathan. Jonathan, what's up?
Open Anthony, how you doing, guys?
All right, what do you got on this case?
I have friends both in California and Jersey, and this is a definite criminal negligence case. If it's not involuntary manslaughter, they can get them on criminal negligence almost 100%. Because they show the necessity that the contest is more important than human life. And since they have prior knowledge of it being a case that even if somebody had died of water intoxication, they signed a waiver, the waiver still wouldn't protect them because they know the consequences of, especially in California, the person of death. When it comes to in the state, if somebody dies, regardless of a waiver or not, they're still held liable based on criminal negligence.
Then what's the use of a waiver? Hello?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
What's the use of a waiver then?
Unfortunately, I'm not really sure what the hell was going on with them, but if their lawyers should have researched a little bit better, they'd realize that in California law, any kind of homicide or even manslaughter, there's nothing that can really even prevent it or stop anybody from being prosecuted as such.
Yeah, there's no waiver for that.
20,000 waivers. No, definitely not. Okay. Even they can sign 20,000 waivers and have a pad full of lawyers, it still wouldn't stop them because the prosecution can get them on that negligence charge, which in turn can land them at least 10 to 15 years in jail minimum.
I think waivers are if something happens that the person giving you the waiver really doesn't have anything to do with, or any negligence is involved, then you're protected. But the second you kind of boost it up by being negligent and stuff, then the people can file suit against you. Thank you. That's my legal knowledge. I watch court TV occasionally. Trying to help out.
All right, well,
we get to hear more of Jennifer here in this next clip.
The dead girl.
The dead girl, yeah. They're trying to get her to drop out of the contest. So yep. This now might save them.
No, I don't think it has anything to do with them trying to get her to drop out to save her life. I think they're trying to get her to drop out because, you know, the bit's running long. And they just want to end this.
And they have to get back to music.
They want a winner. That's it.
Who is this, Jennifer?
This is Jennifer.
Jennifer, what's dead the girl. Situation about Justin Timberlake tonight?
I don't want to... I want the Wii.
You do want the Wii.
I was tempted. I was really, really tempted, and everyone's going to hate me forever.
I got a pair of tickets.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah, they'll hate you.
She sounds nice, too.
I know.
She really does.
What a shame.
It's all silly and fun.
Just having a good time.
Having some water.
She wants to be the talk of the office, you know. Remember when you did that contest? Well...
tempted, and everyone's gonna hate me forever.
I got a pair of tickets, lower level, Justin Timberlake 2007 Future Sex Love Show Live, Arco Arena, tonight, and I will throw them away if you do not want to take them. Or Lucy.
Take the tickets and live.
We're not, trust me,
don't
we're not going to throw them
and
away.
Die.
Take the tickets. Take the tickets.
Take them.
Take them.
No deal.
If she just would have taken the ticket, she may have, she probably would have lived because she sounded okay at that point.
Where's our time machine?
And apparently after that, her not taking the tickets, they increased the size of the water bottles.
Really?
And now made them drink even more water. Yeah, so if she would have taken the tickets, perhaps things would be a little different for them. Right now.
Say no to the tickets and you open the other curtain and it's a satin pillow.
Satin pillow. Grim Reaper standing there showing it like a game show. like the girls at the game show, how they show off the prizes.
Yeah.
It's a satin pillow!
I'm going to have to say... God, this really sucks. No deal.
No deal.
It was that close.
Wow. It was that close. She was really thinking about it.
She was thinking about it.
That could have been the difference right there. Because she ended up drinking more water.
Mm-hmm.
She could have went right to the bathroom and got a lot of that water out of her.
Would have been done deal.
Just like that. She had a decision to make.
Wouldn't have heard about it.
And she wasn't sure. She was like, ooh. It was like kind of a toss-up for a while.
In that moment... She will now, her kids will not have her at their graduation. She'll never see grandchildren.
Yeah.
In that moment.
That split second. That was the fork in the road of life right there. One of the big ones. That was a big interchange. And just, you took the wrong one.
Yeah. She would have went to a show and had fun. And that would be it.
Tony makes a great point in Cleveland. Tony.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Hey, Tony.
Hey, I guess me and Jennifer both have something in common. We'd rather die than see Justin Timberlake.
All right. Doesn't say much for Justin Timberlake. let's go to Steve in Boston. Is he another lawyer? Steve, what's up?
You guys were asking about how the waiver helps or does not help.
Yeah.
The waiver is only going to help you if for a civil case. In other words, you can go ahead and have somebody sign a waiver saying, hey, I won't sue you or my family won't sue you if something happens. But there's absolutely no way you can waive your way out of a criminal prosecution.
Okay.
That's how it makes sense.
So hey, what
guys,
do you...
Go ahead.
Well, yeah, what do you think's going to happen to the morning show?
It's going to be tough. It's going to be a rough time for these guys.
Really?
Yes. They're in trouble.
I think
I would not recommend doing this if I was you guys.
Nah. We did this.
Oh, yeah,
we actually did this contest back in the day.
It's kind of hack anyway. Hey, listen, do you guys still listen to the Little People Story sightings or whatever? Because I got a good one.
Major story.
Oh, jeez. Are you at it? Wow. All right, hold on. We don't like to do it in this fashion, but hold on. Got to find something here. So anyway, Anthony, we're going to play the next track from the Morning Rave Contest.
We interrupt this program.
What?
Huh?
What?
Ozone Midget Sighting of the Day.
What?
Who saw this coming?
Certainly not me.
Steve in Boston, what's up?
You want me to start from the beginning, or you want to hear my little people story?
Beginning of what? I don't understand what you're even talking about.
We have no idea what you're talking about. We're talking about this morning rave thing, and we interrupted the program because it looks like you have a midget sighting.
Well, I had a fantastic midget sighting. Picture this. I'm in Atlantic City. I'm at the craps table. I'm going on a pretty good roll. All of a sudden, my turn is over, and what do I see but just this little white pair of knuckles on the other side of the craps table launching these dice up in the air. Now I'm thinking, what is going on over there? There is a little person, if you will, launching the dice at this craps table. If you can imagine, if you will, nothing but little knuckles coming up from the bottom of the craps table in the air. And I see dice flying out of them. And this little person went on one hell of a roll, won me a lot of money. But these knuckles come out of nowhere. Pretty funny.
Little puffy knuckles. Just those big dice. They look huge in his hand.
It looked like someone was throwing a baseball with a bunch of slugs hanging off of it.
Looks like someone's rolling the dice that hang from your mirror.
Come on, seven. Come on, seven.
Oh, it was great. And there was a little person friend with him and losing money. So he's sitting here trying to get the little person to stop throwing. Little person wants to keep throwing. And all you see every once in a while is a little fat hand every once in a while jumping up.
Oh, wow. That's a good one. That's a good one, sir.
It was good.
All right. Thank you, Steve.
All right, bud.
Meanwhile, back at the show.
Let's say hi to Josh in D.C. Josh, what's up?
What's up, boys?
Hey.
You know, this woman's an idiot. She could have just taken a ticket, scalped them, and probably bought two or three Wii's for herself.
She wanted bragging rights, though, man.
Yeah.
You know we get into these situations with our show. You know, the listeners, they want bragging rights. They want to be the one that says, hey, I won the eggnog drinking contest. I won the whatever contest, you know?
Yeah, but anything's better than dying. Come on.
True. But she didn't know she was going to die. She was just she was living in the moment. Like, no, I want to have bragging rights. They're going to be talking about me on the show for a while.
I'd be thinking about the cash the whole time. I could care less about the system because you can just go buy it. I mean, what difference does it make?
Right.
Yeah, she screwed up, obviously.
All right,
the
guys.
Whole collection of them screwed up.
Yeah, let's say hi to Max in Dallas. Max.
Good morning, boys.
Hey, Max.
Hey, Anthony. Chicks named Jennifer just seem to cause all kinds of problems, don't they?
Yeah, I've noticed a trend, perhaps.
All right. Well, let's say hi to Greg on Long Island. Greg, what's up?
I'm going to try it again.
Okay.
You think Jennifer is the talk of the water cooler?
Well, you know, when you do a radio show, you're looking for water cooler talk. So
yeah.
So Greg might be onto something there. Here's a law student before we get back to the remaining audio.
Cooler.
Yeah, I know. Ron in Connecticut, what's up?
Hey, guys, how you doing? I'm a longtime fan, first-time caller.
All right.
Quack, quack.
I'm a Harvard law student, and technically, if the thing that they sign encompasses death in there's not a whole lot that they can pursue against the radio personalities. But they can really go after the person who signed off on the contest because everything has to be signed off by somebody.
What?
I think you just talked over our heads.
Yeah.
All right, let's get back to the audio. Here we go. Jennifer complains about being in pain. The host says that's what it feels like when one is drowning.
She said drowning.
Oh, drowning, they said?
Yeah.
Oh, you got to give him a break.
No. Well, he's very knowledgeable.
I can understand. You got to give him a break. Jennifer drops out of the contest. So
and life.
Yeah, she does not win the contest in the end.
No.
Jennifer, I heard that it's not. You're not doing too well.
My head hurts.
Oh my God, her voice is. Dude, yeah. I just got chills.
She's she's dying just, right now.
She just went from cute girl. You know, cute sounding girl to that's the real deal happening right now.
See, she is dying right now. Her brain is swelling to the point where she will die. And this is what is happening to her right now. You are listening to a woman who is dying.
Now, if she went right
it's
to the
snuff
hospital.
Audio.
If she went right to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
She would have been fine, probably.
Maybe. Yeah.
They could do something for you, right?
Apparently, we heard yesterday they give you some kind of IV or some crap that the water diluted out of you. But. I don't know.
They go, here, eat this. It's a sponge.
Quick.
Just the timpani sound effect as she's
dying.
Dying.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I know. It's always good to have the nice, wacky, friggin' radio sound effects when a dying woman is talking.
Jennifer, I heard that it's not, you're not doing too well.
My head hurts.
Oh.
They keep telling me that it's the water, that it's my, it'll tell my head to hurt and then it'll make me puke, but
who told you that, the intern?
Yeah.
Oh my God, she's getting advice from an intern.
An intern. Oh, who told you that? That it's the intern? The intern told you?
The intern was smarter than anyone else on the show, though. Knew a little bit about this water intoxication.
Puke, but
Who told you that? The intern?
Yeah.
That's what I noticed over there.
It hurts, but it makes you feel lightheaded, so I'm not sure if I'm just like...
This is what it feels like when you're drowning. There's a lot of water inside of you.
Oh, it hurts.
This is like deep blue sea.
So, we want to get you out of your misery. We would like to offer you again, one more time.
And the last time.
The last time we're going to offer you this. Justin Timberlake tickets for tonight.
Lower level.
Because it seems like Lucy has a big bladder and she's not going anywhere.
You know, they laughed at me for turning them down the first time, so I'm not going to turn them down again. I'll take them.
Oh! Oh, all right, bring them in. Hey, bring everybody in.
Come on, bring them in, everybody. Bring them in.
How creepy was that concert? Two empty seats on the lower level? Just creepy empty seats.
Wonder where those people are.
Yeah,
why didn't they show up?
Oh, well, anyway, I like this song.
Got caught in traffic.
Yeah. Wow. And now, finally, the host comment on how sick Jennifer looks. She can't stand up.
Yeah, she can't stand up.
Uh-oh. Oh, she looks sick. Jennifer, you look oh, my gosh, look at her belly. Are you pregnant?
No, she said it looks like her belly like when she was pregnant. Look, it's totally sticking out.
Oh, my gosh. Look at that belly.
That is so funny.
That's full of water. You ready
to... probably 3 months pregnant.
Come on over.
She's a mother of three.
I know. She's a little tiny
mother
thing, too. That's
three.
So funny.
Come on over, Jennifer. Are you okay? You want to lay down? What do you...
She can't even walk.
You're going to pass out right now? Too much water?
I could probably drink more if you guys could pick me up. Do you want me to?
No.
What can I get for
What can I get? Well, you're going to Justin Timberlake tonight. You got tickets
Thank
for that.
You.
I don't think Lucy was going to give up. So.
Oh.
And no problem with Lucy, I guess, huh?
No.
The eventual winner of the contest.
No, I guess she went in and did her business, got rid of it. Wow. I don't know if Jennifer did.
Wow, that is, I got to be honest, that's really, really
creepy. And I don't know what, you know, implications for the show this audio holds, but that's something. You think it'll come up in court? You think that'll be played 1,000 times in a courtroom?
Of course it will. Of course it will.
You could see that they obviously have knowledge of this water intoxication, did nothing. They're laughing as a woman is dying.
Looks like a family's going to own a few radio stations.
Yep.
This is going to get ugly.
They won't go to jail, though. They won't go to jail because you could hear there was no intent there. I mean, I know it's negligent, but they're all having fun. She's saying she's okay. She sounds fine in the first two clips. Like, there's no way anyone's going to jail.
Yeah, I think it's a big civil suit.
I think what kind of saves them is asking her if she wants to drop out, and she said no. I think that helps a little bit. I'm no lawyer, but I think that helps a little bit.
We offered.
We said, look, you could leave right now. Only you know your body. Only you know what you could take. Here's some concert tickets. What do you say? And at that point, she said no.
That's true, Frank, but I don't think this case is that cut and dry.
There's not much else to say. That's there you go. This story has legs, and we've made the story. Because now they're talking about famous radio stunts.
He said it had legs. I couldn't get the mic fast enough to go, no, you mean fins.
whatever. We made the Mercury News, famous radio stunts. We're under the death and churches category. Shock jocks Opie and Anthony were fired in 1998 from Boston.
We were.
For an April Fool's prank in which they alleged that Mayor Thomas Menino had died in a car crash. In August 2002, they were fired from New York's NEW for a stunt involving a couple allegedly having sex in the vestibule of St. Patrick's Cathedral.
Why I never.
The duo is back on the air, both on XM Satellite Radio and CBS Radio.
Shut up.
All right, well, I guess we'll... Well, a lot of calls coming in, though. Let's say hi to Tom in Jersey. Tom, what's up?
Hey, guys. Yikes. Just want to congratulate you on broadcasting your first snuff film.
Well, how did it feel? Yeah. How did it feel listening to her voice?
Not good. Whew.
Yeah, that's creepy.
Yep. I mean, creepy.
That's eerie.
There, fellas.
I don't know exactly, but she died less than 10 hours later, right?
I think 5 hours later.
Five hours later?
Yeah, went home.
Did she die in her sleep?
Laid down, and I don't think you have a choice. I think, like, you just kind of nodded out. Her brain got all swollen, and she just nodded out. That was it.
A lot of people saying she was an adult. She knew what she was doing. And here's a doctor. We'll end with this. Mike in Jersey. Mike,
hey,
what's
guys,
up?
Hey. Listen, you guys were talking about basically how they could have prevented this. Real easy. If she had gotten to a doctor, gotten to a hospital right after that show, she would have been fine. They put an IV with salt concentrated more than that's in your blood, pulls the water out of your brain, you're good to go.
Simple as that?
It's simple as that. Anyway, one more thing.
Yeah, why wouldn't she go to the hospital?
Doctor, why doesn't he say saline?
You think?
Yes, I could have just said saline, yes. I forgot Professor Anthony was on the line.
Well, he was trying to dumb it down for him.
No, it just makes me think he's not a doctor, and he would just say that to get on the air.
Are you a doctor, Mike? Be honest.
Yes, I am. I'm actually in training to become a urologist.
Ew.
Yeah, it was right.
I like the feeling. You see, Jimmy, some people go in this direction. They're fixated on certain things.
I always found that you just gargle and make a diagnosis.
All right, Mike, thank
you. Only you've seen what I've seen. Hey, one more thing, you guys.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to invoke the R. Kelly defense here. She, you know, maybe should have researched this on her own before she went into a contest drinking tons of water. Similar, what I mean by R. Kelly is...
Well, the scary part is when you participate in some of these contests, you think the radio hosts are experts, and you just assume they did all the research.
Don't assume that ever.
Kind of with our Sex for Sam thing, if you look at it now, how ridiculous was that? Who in their right mind would agree to that contest?
Yeah.
You know, but you're just Joe Listener going, they must have done all their research. Oh, sure, we'll have sex all over the city, and I'm sure it won't be a problem. They obviously talked to the authorities.
Yeah,
and
it
the
can't
police.
Be illegal.
They talked to the lawyers. They ran it past the lawyers.
Oops.
I guess we should announce that, you know, we're just dummies.
Yeah.
We're just dummies trying to get ratings up, that's all.
And by us, we mean all radio people.
Yeah, we're not experts in anything. It's time to admit that.
We have a mic. Just because it's coming out of some electronic device that's in front of you doesn't mean we know what we're talking about.
Right.
We're stupid.
Hey, E-Rock, any communique from one of the members of the Morning Rave that they're thinking about coming on our show?
Nothing yet.
Nothing yet. That means they are...
I'd like to hear from them.
They're lawyering up.
How about Fester, at least? Can we get Fester or Carter?
What about Fester? Yeah, all right, well.
Get Carter.
They're lawyering up, and they're not going to be talking anytime soon. But if they do, I think we have a shot at them.
Yeah.
All right. My Baby is Black. Yeah, it could be the day. American Idol. Same old crap from the night before.
Yeah, it's kind of cool, though. They had some really, really bad people.
All right, we'll figure out what we're going to do next. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hear what everyone else is talking about. ONA Uncut and Live, continuing the show on XM Satellite Radio starting at 9 a.m. Eastern. Visit xmradio.com to subscribe.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
The virus is spreading.
Opie and Anthony! We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. Good morning, Buffalo.
Oh, Buffalo.
How many people are like just, what? Looking at their radios. Yes. Good morning, Buffalo.
Hi, Buffalo.
They know how to support a radio show.
They certainly do.
They know what's going on. They're telling friends. They're spreading the virus in Buffalo. Kicking ass in Buffalo.
Totally.
Thank you so much. Yeah, because, you know, they moved some shows around up there in Buffalo. We moved into Shred and Reagan's slot, and we're like, oh, boy. They can revolt easily. Uh-huh. Easily. Because, you know, Shred and Reagan were in the seats for like 10 years.
Yep.
They moved to afternoons. And we're doing very well in mornings in Buffalo. And guess what? Shred and Reagan kicking ass in afternoons.
Lucky bastards.
Good morning, Buffalo. Yeah, no kidding. We would trade you. We would trade you.
That'd be nice.
We'll take the afternoon slot again. No worries there.
Imagine what it would be like to be like doing morning radio for years, and then you do afternoons where it's like, oh, my God, this is what a life is like? This is what it's like to have a real life. Yeah.
I live better like this, man. When the week we were off, my girlfriend, this is the way I live. Like, normally, I would go to bed at 6 and get up at 4 in the afternoon. She's like, this is the way you used to do it. I'm like, I'm the worst.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
I like getting up in the morning because I live like a human being.
Yeah, I don't mind it at all. Let's say hi to Kristen in Connecticut. Kristen.
I'm an afternoon guy.
Yes, hi. Guys, hi. Thanks for the buzz kill this morning. Seriously.
But you couldn't turn off the radio, right?
I know. It was like watching a train wreck. I felt really guilty. Like, I was vicariously listening and just really bummed out about it. And now I'm on my way to my clients. I drive an hour and a half. You need to play something. Do something happy, please. I'm begging you.
All right. We'll do something happy.
Thank you.
I mean, how did it feel listening to that, though?
It was incredibly creepy. Very, very creepy. Like, just hearing her voice, she seemed so sweet. But what I was thinking is, her poor kids are probably, like, feeling guilty because she's probably trying to win it for them.
Did they get a Wii?
Yeah, and the kids probably like, Mom, I want a Wii, and she's like, I don't have the money for it, so she tries to win it for them, and the kids probably have to live with feeling like they, you know, had something to do with it.
Well, that's what they get for being such bad boys and girls.
Boy, a little brat.
Don't worry, they're going to get plenty of gifts in the coming weeks.
That's true.
Nah, honestly,
that.
There's no real jokes there. I was listening to that, and for the first time in a while, I was getting, like, just... the douche chills, like, ugh, this is a little rough.
I almost started crying, honestly. I'm not that much of a wuss.
Oh, don't cry.
Yeah. All right, we'll do something happy, Kristen. Thank you.
All right, thanks.
Thanks for not turning it off. And Anthony and I were talking during the break.
Could you see if she just wrapped around a telephone pole and is dead now? That last caller? I'm just saying how eerie would be, but we would never know because we don't know who she is. How many times has that happened?
Hopefully a lot.
Just trying to diffuse the... the death audio we heard from the woman.
We just heard death audio.
You never know. That's what I'm saying.
Death audio.
A death dedication.
Yeah,
I'm Casey Kasem.
I'm sort of going there, yeah. Well, we were talking during the break. Good Morning America now just played the audio that we just played.
Yep.
Or, well, you know, it's TV, so they can't go long form at all. So they played like 10 seconds of it.
A couple of snippets. A
couple of quick clips of it. And I'm thinking to myself, how did this audio get out? And stupid me, I'm thinking back in the old days. Anthony and I can't tell you how many times we were doing some crazy thing on the radio, and a general manager would come running in, all sweaty in his suit, his hair is all just out of place because he's been rubbing his hair like, oh, my God, what to do? And general managers would run in and go, if anyone calls and says that they need a tape of this show, just tell them we don't tape your show, and then would run back out.
No tapes.
There's no tapes, right?
Meanwhile, everything was taped.
Yeah, our policy is we don't tape anything around here, okay? Understood? Just in a panic. But you can't use that defense anymore. Radio stations would use that defense with the FCC. Look, you know, because the FCC would get a complaint or something like, really, they did what? We need to hear this.
Yeah, we need tape of it.
To see if there were any violations. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, the company would get back to the FCC and go, we don't tape anything.
Tape,
we don't have any copies of that.
Occasionally we've taped stuff, but not that day.
No, we...
What day were you looking for? No, not that day.
No, and, you know... But now it's different. Everybody's taping all the freaking time.
Yeah.
Everything is recorded.
Listeners.
So that defense doesn't work anymore. I remember Bruce Mittman back up in Boston just running in a panic on so many afternoons going, if there's a tape of what you just did, destroy it. You understand me, right?
The homosexuals are angry, boys. So destroy any tapes that you might have. Wink, wink. Love that guy.
All right. How about American Idol?
Yeah, saw it.
I don't think we need to spend too much time on it today.
It's getting torturous.
It's pretty much the same as the first night.
It was from Seattle.
Dude, 37.3 million viewers.
Huge.
First night of American Idol.
It was from Seattle, and it just reinforced that whole Seattle too cool for their own good, think they are so hip. And meanwhile, they just sucked. A bunch of artsy-fartsy people, you know, the tree-hugger variety type that just want to, like, piss their parents off. So they spike their hair and dye it a wacky color and pierce everything and think that's new. And then they come up on stage and proceed to make total asses of themselves. Which is pretty much what they did. I think they got a total of 7 usable people Seattle. Yeah. About 16,000.
Even when the bad singers weren't really good enough to really fun. Like
it was full of red singers and retarded people. There seems to be a lot of retarded people in Seattle. Like, really, there's something wrong with them, mental, physically.
They're getting too much water.
Is that what it is?
It's a rainy city.
It is really.
I'm making a rain joke.
The first day was rain. The first day they had the auditions, it was raining. And then the second day was nice and sunny.
Too much water on the brain.
Water on the brain.
They're saturated.
They stunk.
They can't think quite right.
And they had the cute little retards that they like to exploit sometimes. You know, where they team up two freak show people and make them look like they're the best of friends for their time that they're auditioning together. Yeah. They did it last year with a couple of retards. They did it this year, too. And everybody, Simon is, like, really nasty to a lot of the people that come in. But these two retards came in, like, not at the same time, one after the other. And they were being very, very nice to them. Because they even knew, oh, my God, we will be killed if we goof on the retarded. And they are so obviously retarded.
Really? Like, yeah. For real retarded?
Yeah, well, like, definitely something. That fat kid was retarded.
There's some inbreding in his past.
Inbreding. We put a little inbreading on the turkey and baste it, and voila, it's wonderful.
Yeah, there was some kind of inbreding going on.
Inbreding.
That's my new thing.
Inbred crumbs.
And by the way, did I call it with the security guards? It kind of takes away from how tough Simon really is.
We were talking about this yesterday.
We're like, hey, of course they're all real brave. They got muscle right to the right off camera.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying yesterday. And sure enough, one of the contestants tried to mousse up Simon's hair or something.
Yeah,
some gel or whatever in his hair.
They were goofing on him.
And you saw these two big, huge security guys come running into the frame.
To escort him out of the...
I think that takes away from Simon's meanness.
Really?
Yeah. I thought he was kind of all alone there.
You got to know, he's kind of an asset, kind of a commodity for the program. They don't want some guy coming over there and punching him square in the face, putting him in a coma.
And the other door gag is just great.
Yeah, I noticed it the first night I was watching it. I'm like, this is a gag. It's a bit. They have double doors.
There's no reason to have one door locked.
Right. It's double doors going in and out of the audition room. They lock one of them and leave one open. So that when somebody's all dejected, they hit the wrong door, and Simon just goes, other door.
Other door.
All disgusted. You hear, tchum. Sometimes they don't even show the person leaving. You just hear that, tchum, and Simon's face going, other door. It's a great bit.
And they probably tell them, like, before they go in, all right, just leave. You come in through the right door, you leave through the left door.
Yeah, leave through the left, tchum, other door. But you shut up.
So you want to hear Kenneth and Jonathan, or you want to hear the psycho guy, Nicholas, the software guy?
Any of these that we have clips of would be fine. The psycho guy was, again, another guy that's just crazy. They say you can really tell if someone's crazy if you can see the whites of their eyes underneath and above the color part of your eye. And you absolutely could on this guy.
The girl I used to date told me that there's a term for it because every one of our listeners had it. F.H. Riley's.
F.H. Riley's? Did you say F.H. Riley's?
I did. It was, I believe, in Huntington Avenue in Huntington, New York.
400.
400, of course. I meant to say that.
Yeah. Part of Huntington on Long Island.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Our restaurant.
Yes, sir.
It's a fine restaurant owned by the Opie Hughes and his brother. And we went out there and had some good cheesecake, but a listener showed up, and they were all had that three-quarters white thing showing. And
yeah.
There's a term for that, and she told me the term, and I forgot what it was.
Crazy.
Yeah, nuts.
It's called crazy. And this guy had it. His eyes are just wide open, and he sang one of Simon's favorite songs.
Unchained Melody.
Unchained Melody.
I guess this would be the hit of the show last night. It was all right. It wasn't as good as the first night.
Yeah, he was
I don't think we need to play Kenneth and Jonathan. It goes on forever. It's just,
what, the two retarded guys?
Yeah.
But if we could get a little of the fat kid singing, that's all I want.
Which
He's
one was
got
he?
A lift, I think. Was he the one that looked like a monkey? Because Simon... There was one of these guys was deformed.
Right.
He had some kind of deformity where he was half midget. That's the fat guy.
All right, we got the fat guy singing.
God
God bless America.
Yeah. Get a lift, too.
Land that I love.
There you go. Take it down.
Stand beside her and guide.
It's like if Cartman was a human being, a real human.
Oh, my God. It is.
He is the living Cartman.
Listen, he's the living Cartman. You could kind of hear it in his voice.
You guys? Yeah, I'm ready to perform.
He's the living Cartman.
God bless America.
You guys?
Land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her.
Hey. Sounds real good.
Unless you're a stupid Jew.
He's been practicing a lot upstairs in the holding room, so he's sounds like he's ready.
That's his simian friend.
Yeah, listen through the door.
To the oceans, white with foam, God bless America, my home, sweet home.
Oh, beautiful. Nice. Yes, Simon just says, beautiful. Woof.
What did the judges say to him?
Wow. They were being nice to him. They really, like... We're overly nice to this kid
because
he was obviously he had some type of mental problems. Do we have more of his singing? Because I think he sang another song.
Yeah, well, they weren't sure if he was going to go to Hollywood or not.
Yeah.
So they said, hey, you got to sing another one. So I believe it was Styx.
Yeah.
Come Sail Away. Styx. Yeah.
Wow, they seem to like the music that isn't there for the auditions.
Well, I figured they'd help him along a little more than the other contestants.
I'm sailing away.
This ain't bad.
Set an open course for the Virgin Sea. Cause I've got to be free. Free to face the life that's ahead of me.
Fantastic.
I'm burdened and the kitten, so climb and burn. Research for to marry on every ship, but with that, a load of dread.
Here it comes. Must have hurt so bad to sing like
that. Okay, there you go. A little taste. I mean, it goes on for 6 minutes. Oh, trust me, I would love to listen
crazy
to the whole
long.
Thing right now. Hey, Carrie from New York, actually Jersey, knows the term for the white eyes thing. Carrie, what's up?
Hi.
Hey, Carrie.
Hi.
I'm not sure that this is the same thing we're talking about, but there's a book about it. That's called Sanpakou.
Sanpakou.
You know what language that comes from? Maybe French.
San what?
Sanpakou.
Yeah, I think it is right.
What?
Sanpakou or something. I forget what it is.
Yeah, when you can see the white around the color part. Like, they said that about the runaway bride. Remember the runaway bride?
Right.
You could see the white surrounding the color part of her eyes. But, yeah, that just rang a bell. It's a book. It's like
getting your medical knowledge.
Why does that mean you're nuts?
Runaway bride.
It just means you don't have, proper eyelids.
Maybe because your psychos always open their eyes a certain amount, or maybe that's just nature's way of letting the rest of us know you're an ass.
Yeah, but you would get tired trying to keep your eyes open that long.
But you can always tell a googly-eyed kook, like someone whose eyes are always bugged out wide, is normally a problem. Yeah. There's never a subtle, gentle person with their eyes bugged out like
that. No.
All right, let's go to Mike in Jersey. Mike, what's up?
Mike.
What's going on, gentlemen? Hey. Do you have the clip of Simon telling the kid with Agent Orange that he looked like a monkey or a lemur or something like that?
Yeah, he said he looked like a bush baby. But he was trying to... Yeah, I think he did look like a lemur or something.
All right, you want
to
hear that?
He had some kind of physical deformity.
All right, yeah, so that other guy, his friend with the googly eyes, performed, and then I guess this is what Simon had to say. I hope this is the right track.
Well, Simon said that my dancing was horrendous, my singing was terrible, and he compared me to a monkey.
Okay, so you've gone, you didn't make it.
All right, so that's after he left.
Yeah.
I gotta find it. Hold on a minute.
He was really bad, but again, they were nice to him because he was deformed.
Kenneth, you and I need to have a conversation, I think.
I love
First of all, you are aware this is a singing competition. Right. So why do you think you could win?
Because I have a good voice. And I believe that I am the next American Idol. In fact, I know I am.
Right. Well, you look a little odd. Your dancing is terrible. The singing was horrendous. And you look like one of those creatures that live in the jungle with those massive eyes. What are they called? Bush baby.
Simon, you are set.
Simon, you're crazy.
Simon.
He's
no, Randy.
Sick.
It's
crazy.
Okay.
No, but
Randy,
I'm just
it's
being...
okay. Yeah, it's
sick.
Okay. Simon, you're going to say what you're going to say. But you know what?
Yep.
That's your opinion. You're entitled to it.
But it's a pretty good opinion.
Yeah.
It really is a pretty good opinion in the end.
And his opinion...
Whether you like him or hate him, it's a pretty good opinion.
And his opinion is pretty much what makes or breaks you.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's say hi to Kirk in Jersey. Kirk.
Yeah.
Hey, this kid was the spitting image of Gollum from Lord of the Rings.
That's yep. it. That's it.
Looked like Gollum.
There you go.
That's what your defense is, though, when you have no answer to somebody. Like, get that. That's your opinion.
It's your opinion. Well, let me tell you, buddy boy.
Pally. All right. This is what they said of the fat kid. Are we going back to this? All right.
Yeah, the fat kid.
A little. Jimmy asked, what did they say?
Yeah, because I
God bless America thing.
Live action Cartman.
Look, Jonathan, look, you're a nice guy, right? I like you. But this is not the career path for you. It's enough.
Okay.
Thank
Sorry,
you, Jonathan. Thanks for coming out, dude.
Always believe in yourself because you'll make it through with something.
You're at the right door.
All right. And then they play the music and,
yeah, and then
have
you
them
see
walk off together. Two freaks of nature.
He's paced.
I think we have time to do Psycho Nicholas. I think this was the highlight of the show. This guy was a very creepy, uncomfortable in his own skin, doesn't really know how to socialize. He does software and has no business, obviously, trying out for American Idol.
A real creep.
What is it about yourself that makes you the next American Idol?
I am a leader.
You're a leader.
Yes, I can project myself real well. I can
army of none.
L-I-T-E-N.
Prior situations that I've been in before, I've been kind of the leader voice of choirs that I've been
That's good.
In. And how old are you?
27.
27.
What makes you unique apart from being a good leader?
What makes me unique? I don't really have a good answer for that, but I just like to think I'm a lot different than a lot of other people.
Would you say your voice sets you apart from everyone else?
I would say so, yes. That's a
yeah.
You know, why don't you show us what you're talking about? What are you gonna sing?
Okay, I am going to sing Unchained Melody by the Righteous Brothers.
That's Sonny's favorite song.
That's what I've been told.
I want to know when Nicolas Cage went out for America. He sounds exactly like stupid Nicolas Cage.
Wow, I didn't notice that because I've seen him. So
yeah,
I could just picture that, looks like, that lunatic. Yeah. But you hear, oh, he's all pasty mouth and can't talk. Yeesh.
Well, this is what he's saying. Listen to this.
Oh, my love, oh, my darling, I hunger for your touch and awe and lonely time. And time goes by.
Wait for the good part.
Oh, yeah.
And time can do so
much. There's a big payoff coming up.
Are you still mine? I need your love. Love to me, lonely rivers run to the sea, to the open arms of the sea. Yeah.
Riverside. He's feeling comfy.
Wait for me.
Yeah.
I'll be coming home. Wait for me. Oh, oh, my love. Oh, my darling. I hunger for your touch. Alone and lonely tonight.
Thank you, Nicholas.
They let him go because they know he was just making an ass of him.
Yeah.
Stephen from Bayshore, that sounded more like Unbrained Melody.
Yeah.
I've got a new life you would hardly recognize. I'm so glad I'm a new person.
She should have been on. She should have been a star.
She would have been the star of American Idol.
I saw the sign, and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. Life is demanding without understanding. I saw the sign, and it opened up my eyes. I saw the sign. No one's gonna drag you up to get into the light where you belong.
And then someone else is saying that guy, it sounds like he's about to go to die.
I play the lute, Simon.
The lute.
Yeah. The lute. I'm a lutist.
You just call Andy. It's time. Sting. Just call him. Get it done. Stop teasing it. Get it done.
I saw the signs.
Yeah, I know. All right. This is what they said to Psycho Nicholas. They just were as honest as possible
yeah.
in this one.
What the bloody hell was that?
It was me.
It's honest.
Is that not good enough?
No.
Not even close.
Okay.
So that would be a yes or a no, Simon.
One of the worst I've ever heard.
So that would be a no?
It was almost non-human.
It was really, really bad, dude. Out of tune, bad tone, weird tone, actually. Not pleasant. None of the things you want singing to be. Yeah.
Thank you, sweetheart.
All right, good looking out, man.
So when will you sing again?
I don't really know. Maybe next year, or maybe, I don't know. Pretty much all I have to say about that.
Yeah. It was a Forrest Gump line. Guess I gotta go.
Guess I gotta go.
Yeah, Castor Troy.
All right. People are asking for the first one, Hotness.
Oh, the Hotness.
Yeah, maybe we'll play when we get back. We really got to step aside for a little bit. I don't know.
The Hotness was a slob.
She should call herself the Ugliness.
Oh.
There was nothing hot about the Hotness.
Her mouth looked like a it looked like the opposite end of your mouth. Like, you know when you eat, you put the food in your mouth?
Yeah.
Looks like the opposite end of that.
Especially
that whole process.
Especially if you eat Taco Bell a lot.
Yeah. That's what it looked like. She got like it was like she had a lip transplant.
Old cinnamon lips.
Yeah.
Do you think she's hot, Jimmy? There's a picture of her. That's the Hotness.
No, not really.
She goes by the Hotness.
And they asked her why she's called the Hotness, and apparently it was because in high school she was kind of wild and popular. And I was laying there in bed watching. I go, oh, okay. She was the whore in high school. She was just the whore.
She looks like Fred Gwynn, but she's like,
I'm the Hotness, Lily. Lily, I'm the Hotness.
Looks like she worked out those lips a little too much.
Grandpa, I need a singing potion, Grandpa. Okay, Hyman. She does look like Fred Gwynn. Oh, if you're the Hotness, you should not even resemble anything of Fred Gwynn.
You better make sure you're hot if you're going to call yourself the Hotness.
The Hotness.
There should never, ever be a question.
Not a hint of Fred Gwynn should be in right. you if you're the Hotness.
Jessica Biel.
Do you look at Jessica Biel and think anything of Fred Gwynn?
No.
Of course
Jessica
not.
Jessica Biel could call herself the Hotness. Not this broad.
course.
With puffy lips. Not even
big
good puffy lips.
Cinnamon lips.
Sometimes you see a puffy lip. You know, lips, they're nice.
Shut up. Double chin. Scarlett Johansson. The hotness.
The hotness.
You could call her the hotness.
Oh, yeah. Stalker Patty.
Exactly.
All right, we'll give you a taste of the hotness.
What's going on, Jennifer?
Not a lot. Ready to get my sang on.
You know you can.
Get my sang on.
By the way, listen very closely. They did something a little different with the hotness here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Hmm.
A little different. They ended her audition a little differently.
What's going on, Jennifer?
Not a lot. Ready to get my sang on.
You know you can't sing with gum in your mouth.
Oh, gum.
Can I throw this away somewhere?
Stick it on Taylor's face or something.
No, I got it. No, it's cool. I got it. Today, I'm going to be singing Tenderoni. I Want Your Love.
Okay.
Baby, I think of you. I think of you a million times a day. Baby, I cannot get you outside my head. And baby, I'm crazy, and it's always about you. All that I know is I belong to you. Oh, baby, I want your love.
Yes, she was tasered right there. A new addition to American Idol.
The first contestant to be tased on American Idol. It happened last night with the hotness.
Oh.
Are we weighing E-Rock next?
Yes. Great.
Sam's alarms went up. He was so happy about
it. I know.
E-Rock.
Anytime E-Rock is being goofed on, Sam is happy.
E-Rock, we're going to make a deal with you today. Do you feel adventurous?
Ooh.
Are you willing to be adventurous? Yes or no?
Yes.
Wow.
That means you will do what we say next. Yes or no? You won't die.
Drink 2 gallons.
No, you won't die. And you won't be naked. Yes.
Well, that's it.
Or no?
Yes.
He said yes.
Wow.
Montage! We weigh E-Rock next. It's the Opie and Anthony show, and he said he would be adventurous.
It's the Opie and Anthony show! The Opie and Anthony virus.
It's the Opie and Anthony show.
Oh, Jimmy's dancing.
I hope you know that by now.
Swim walking.
Jimmy's off to Chicago.
Yes, tonight, tomorrow, and Saturday. 3 different zanies in Chicago. And I'm doing Steve Dahl's show tomorrow, which I'm very psyched about.
Very cool. So make sure you check out Jim on WCKG in the Chicago area tomorrow in the afternoon there.
I'm going to have a lunch with the staff, the sales staff. It's going to be a barn burner.
They're really into the show in Chicago.
CKG, yeah.
They're really into it. Nothing really happening with the ratings yet in Chicago, but they're into the show. They're believing in the show. So we'll see what happens in the coming months. But Jimmy's going up there to do his comedy and also kind of take a look and see what Chicago's all about for us.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully we'll be up there very, very soon. Well, not very soon. It's winter. We're not stupid.
Yeah.
When it gets nice and warm, we'll visit your fine city and take a look around.
Because I'd like to look around.
Yeah.
I don't want to go to a city and have to stay in a hotel room because it's 5 degrees out.
Correct.
Thank you.
It'd be funny if they pushed me in the conference room and then just raped me while making me read the numbers out loud.
This is what you're doing to us!
Strangely sexy.
Anyway, are we ready yet? Kinda? E-Rock. E-Rock gained a lot of weight during the holiday.
Oh, tons.
And
packed it on.
What was it, 19 pounds we figured? You said 15, but then you openly admitted you weighed 200 pounds before Christmas, and we weighed you at 219.
Mm-hmm.
So you gained about 20 pounds.
How tall are you, E-Rock?
5'11".
Okay.
He's not a fat guy, but he just looks like he shouldn't be fat.
He's a big boy.
Some people should be fat. Some people, you know, that's your thing. You're fat. You look good. You look fine. You look healthy even as a fat guy. E-Rock, on the other hand, doesn't look like he should be a fat guy. Or no. Even a little bit chubby.
Because he's not muscular. Like, he has the body consistency of a cyst.
Danny, are you ready?
It's what they call doughy.
And before the break, doughy. You did say that you're going to be adventurous for the show today, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not knowing what we had planned for you, right?
No.
Well, basically, Rock, we're not weighing you today. Or maybe we will later. I don't know. Because it's obvious he's losing the weight. What we have decided instead, Danny, if you will, come on in. It's Danny, everyone, representing the staff of the Opie and Anthony show.
Oh, no. Where did Danny get that?
I think one of the interns brought it in, right? One of the new guys?
His closet.
Oh, hold on. There you go.
No, a faithful listener helped us out with this one.
He came by with this?
Yeah, he dropped it off this morning.
Danny, because it is radio, what are you holding up?
This is a lovely pink bunny suit.
Is that from a Shining prop auction? Hope it's been washed.
It's a pink, yes, bunny costume, complete with
mask,
little bunny hat,
and booties.
And booties.
It's got little ears on the little bunny hat. It looks like a Christmas story.
Yeah,
exactly. When he gets his little bunny suit for Christmas morning and opens up his presents.
Little pink mittens.
It's pink mittens. What is that for?
That's the booty.
Booty.
Yeah. So, E-Rock, okay. This is what's going to happen. Yeah, you're going to put on the pink bunny suit, and you're going to do Chubby Bunny today. We got marshmallows.
Marshmallows.
Hurry up. We're running out of time. And you will wear the pink bunny suit as we walk over to XM.
And don't choke to death yes. in the bunny suit. Although it would be hysterically funny. It would be so ironic.
Yeah. As E-Rock puts the pink bunny suit on and gets ready to do Chubby Bunny. Of course, we're taping this. The video will be up on opieandanthony.com. All our videos are up on opieandanthony.com.
Yeah, a lot of people say, hey, what are you doing? This is visual. We can't see the bunny suit on the radio. Hey, Larry King, you have a computer, right? We put all these videos up on various websites. They always end up on YouTube.
Unlike Larry King,
right?
The rest of America knows exactly how to use
we know
the internet.
About technology, my girlfriend said I should make phone calls with a BlackBerry, but I got juice all over my face. I'm a blithering old fool.
E-Rock, you gotta hurry. We're running out of time here.
Why'd you sniff it and make a face, Eric?
It smells.
Smells like what?
What does it smell like?
Uh-oh.
It smells like an attic.
It's like old and musty smell.
Well, it's not like it's getting a lot of use. It's
grandma.
It's not many uses for a pink bunny suit.
Once a year it comes out, the Easter bunny thing. And that isn't even like, no one does that anymore.
Anthony, as E-Rock puts on the pink bunny suit, we got your CSI, David Caruso, line of the day.
All right.
Or a few of them, actually.
I love it.
Here's today's batch.
What about witness statements? So far, just a lot of confusion. Jury only had 1 week before deliberations. No need now. The verdict is in.
No need now.
The verdict is in.
Right. So where's the...
Skip down? Why? We've heard it? Okay. Yeah. We'll go to this one.
I can't remember anything. Okay. Listen, I don't want you to worry about it, all right, Mr. Coleman? Because I'll be your memory.
Boy. All right.
Oh.
Another one.
Gang shootings usually go down on the streets in their own territories. This time, it was in a public place.
So they brought the war to us. Now we are going to take it to them.
it's like an SNL parody sketch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That is not really an actor acting on the number one rated show.
Now, everyone is onto this. Obviously, the video on YouTube, forget about it.
Yeah,
it's
huge.
Getting viewed like crazy. But I'm surprised it took so long for everyone to realize what was going on with this guy.
Yeah.
He had a ride-along.
4 or 5 babysitting service. You ask me.
Civilians should be in a patrol car.
Frank, where is Patrick now?
Well, I don't know. He's missing from the scene. Maybe he took off.
Or maybe he got taken for a ride.
All right, enough. We could go on with the CSI David Caruso thing, but E-Rock is in the pink bunny suit. You look like an adult baby. You look like an adult baby. You look like a plushie, yeah. Oh, is this creepy?
We actually got that from Michael Devlin's basement.
Michael Devlin bit.
Yeah, you really, wow.
What a creep.
Oh, my God. Look at it. I didn't look at his whole, look at his face.
Yeah, it's kind of a like a bunny mask.
You kind of really fit that.
You got the perfect face for the pink bunny suit. It's slightly chubby.
Oh, you are a chubby bunny.
All right, listen, we only got a couple minutes left on this side of the Opie and Anthony show before we walk over to XM, so it's time for Chubby Bunny with E-Rock.
Please don't choke. I need this gig.
it's what they do at county fairs and Girl Scout meetings. You put a marshmallow in your mouth, and you say, Chubby Bunny, and then you put another marshmallow in your mouth, and you say, Chubby Bunny. You do not swallow the marshmallows.
Mushroom.
And you keep doing this until you can't anymore, and then you spit them out. What is the record? What is the ONA record, by the way?
20.
By you, right?
Yeah.
All right. He's got the current record. But it's... the Pal Talkers can see this?
Yeah.
A nice close-up of him.
They got a good close-up of his face.
All right.
And the bunny suit. He will be walking over to XM dressed like that, right?
Absolutely.
Okay. I wasn't sure.
And Sam's got his camera.
And my camera.
And the videos will be up on opieandanthony.com later today. Here we go.
Chubby Bunny.
Felch.
Chubby Bunny.
Hate to have to do the Heimlich on a bunny.
No.
Don't laugh.
Cut the hole out of the back of the
Chubby
costume.
Chubby Bunny.
No laughing.
No laughing.
Make you choke.
There's no laughing at Chubby Bunny.
Chubby Bunny.
Ugh.
Chubby Bunny.
It's yes. Five, you goose egg.
Chubby Bunny. Chubby Bunny.
How many are we up to?
Seven.
Seven?
Chubby Bunny.
People want to cut off his feet for good luck. Don't laugh. Stop it.
No laughing.
Chubby Bunny.
I'm all nervous because some woman choked at a county fair doing this. That's
and
how
died.
We figured it out.
And this is
she died.
And that's when we decided we needed to do this on our show. I guess you're right. Hey, we got quite an audience, so.
Who wouldn't want to see this?
We'd have to snake his throat out with Travis.
How many are we up to? Anyone counting?
No.
Are they counting on Pal Talk?
Stop laughing.
I think they're
10. I think the same. No, someone else just said 12.
What?
Two. I give him two.
All right, he'll give us the count. He's keeping track. Uh-oh. Oh, no, he's having problems. You know you could die from fatness.
This is how he eats his lunch.
Uh-oh.
Problem.
Oh, God.
Careful.
Careful. We like this gig.
God.
Wow, he looks like he's having a real problem. Oh, boy.
Breathe through your nose. I don't want the slippery ones to slip back and...
Yeah. Who else is really nervous right now?
His epiglottis and just like...
Who else is really nervous right now?
I'm nervous slash turned on.
All right, spit it out, you ass. He's saying no.
He said no. We got on camera.
Oh, yeah. We know how well that works. Oh. Get rid of it. Oh, God. It came out in a big lump.
He got it out? All right.
Yeah.
And that's how we end the show today. E-Rock in a pink bunny suit.
How many?
Doing Chubby Bunny for the Opie and Anthony show. The video will be up on opieandanthony.com. How many, E-Rock?
Good boy.
You lost count?
Yeah. You have to skip in that outfit.
Why don't you count them in the... someone is saying 18.
Just short of the record.
You know, if he would have died doing that, we wouldn't have been able to take the bunny suit off because you can't mess with any evidence. So they'd, like, had to haul him out in that coroner's gurney in a bunny suit.
All right. Hope you had fun today. We had a great time.
Sam. It's a dead rabbit, Sam.
If you're not joining us over at XM, have yourself a great day. Thanks for listening.
Bye.
Go see Jimmy at Zany's in Chicago for all you guys in the Chicago area.
Ooh.
And listen to him on WCKG tomorrow afternoon with Steve Dahl. Bye. Thanks, guys.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey, what's up? This is Bill Burr. Just letting you know I'm going to be at the Improv in Washington, D.C., District of Columbia, January 18th through the 21st. You can call 202-296-7008 for tickets or go to improvclubs.com. Thank you.
Relax. Get busy with the facts. Those zodiacs are all relaxed. Maniacs, polyester slack.
Opie and Anthony are taking a break from the XM walkover today because it's too fucking cold. You can still join the crew of the Opie and Anthony show for the walk to XM, but we're just not going to broadcast it. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this classic moment from the ONA archives.
What's the temperature today?
50 below my asshole.
are the most vile, despicable human beings in the country. Creeps. Ankle biter.
Obviously, the strength is their ability to turn mistruth into something people would believe.
Wow, how long is this guy going to continue to babble and say nothing?
All day long!
Shut up!
All right, here we go.
Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show.
It's worse than I imagined.
That's terrible.
I'm sorry.
We are a bunch of dopes.
I think we're lewd.
And we're probably pushing 20 arrests because of this radio show.
Out of touch, cornballs.
Three retards.
We have the effect of Tylenol PM.
Opie.
You know I could have been a model.
Anthony.
I'm gay.
James Norton.
I like yogurt.
Robert Reed.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
All right, yeah, we should be around 12:40 to do that for you there. Yeah, like I said, Ant and I will talk on MSNBC, right? Cool. Yeah, we'll get Anthony, too.
What?
No, you got my... You get the phone you just called. Just call that and we'll... is it live on MSNBC at 12:40? 12:35, you'll call Ant and I and we'll be on with Allison Stewart on MSNBC. Green lighted. We're green lighted. Okay. All right, cool. They're calling me in. I got to do my show now. All right. Bye. You want to do it?
What is it? What is this?
They want some professionals to talk about.
Oh no!
Shock radio. I told you we would be dragged into this story.
I remember doing this. Not doing this. I remember being part of this, watching at home
right.
as other people commented on my career
right.
and being really pissed off about it.
Well, now it's our turn.
It's our turn.
What they did was wrong.
I am outraged. Let me get my
I'm outraged.
I'm outraged.
This show should never be allowed to do radio ever again.
This has put a black mark on radio.
Right.
You know, when Marconi first invented the radio.
I told you.
Oh, boy.
I told you they would drag us in. It's happening.
Let me practice. we have on the phone right now shock jocks Opie and Anthony. You might remember they themselves got into trouble a few years ago by having a couple engage in sexual activity at St. Patrick's Cathedral, which led to their firing, but they are back on the air on XM Satellite Radio and various FM radio stations across the country. Opie and Anthony, welcome.
Hi, thank you. Thanks for having us, Allison.
Thanks for having us, Allison. Okay, guys, let's get right into this.
Okay, you talk. It's your show.
That'll start us off on the right foot. Guys, you're familiar with this story. How do you feel about this? What happened?
Well, Allison, it's a tragic day for radio.
Yeah.
You know, I never thought it would get to the point where listeners would actually die.
Ah, yes, yes. Yes, we were hoping to be the first show to kill a listener.
Absolutely. And if you looked at our
because look
ratings,
at all the press they're getting.
We really need a listener to die to get the talk up.
Actually, if you look at the New York ratings, Allison, you would assume we had killed all our listeners. But no, hopefully there's a few still out there.
No, Allison, the reality is our dummies don't know how to take care of the Opie and Anthony show.
The show's all about Allison.
Allison.
You know,
be a
great answer.
Yeah, this is going to be great.
If they ask you what you thought of it, go, well, you know, we've done research, and Jennifer was, she was a cunt.
Oh, fuck. we've lost the feed.
But with no rancor at all, no anger, just gentle.
Just say it as a matter of fact.
Yeah. I guess we have to tell people that, why all the nakedness today?
What? Wow. All? How many do you have up?
Is it Naked Thursday on Pal Talk today?
I got one. I usually pop up. I usually make sure our cams are all up first.
Mm.
No, today I was like popping up a couple of other cams first.
Someone is saying we need to say, needless to say.
Needless to say.
Oh, dude, you got to get some phrases in. That's what you guys got to do.
All right.
Oh.
Write down some phrases.
I want to say that we're bummed because we've been knocked down to the second most outrageous radio stunt ever.
We're going to get ourselves fucked. I'm talking about a bad thing.
Look, you guys put up enough money, not that I need the money, but just for the goof factor, you put up enough money when she like asked that first question that's really serious. I'll do obnoxious laugh, man.
No.
She's dead. You see?
You want to see what words we can at least get in? Like I bet I'll slip in Frankus and make it sound normal.
If you get a Frankus in there,
I will get a Frankus in there.
House, this is what we call a Frankus.
I was thinking maybe a name. Right. It's like, tragically, if you remember, years ago, this happened to a DJ named Bill Frankus. but the woman didn't die, so it's there has been a precedent in this.
The Frankus incident.
Frankus incident.
Frankus. They go,
Frankus.
Well, Allison, we recently held our eggnog drinking contest, and
yes.
We could have had similar results, but we were responsible broadcasters. Blah, 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 blah.
You know, you have to make sure there are EMTs on site,
mm-hmm.
so that if any of the contestants get in any kind of medical distress, there is somebody there, a professional that can care for them, because we are but stupid shock jocks.
Right.
We know not of the medical profession.
We're getting help from the instant feedback.
Oh, good.
Allison, our thoughts and prayers go out to Jennifer and her family.
Yeah, thoughts and prayers.
This is a trying time for the family, and I suggest that maybe someone out there should just buy the kids a Wii at this point.
We would like to offer
Wii.
You know, there's little we can do now. They've lost a parent, but we would like to buy a Wii for the children.
Someone is suggesting, God, we got some old school listeners, that we use some Psycho Mark lines.
Go F yourself?
No, the whole, they're not going to be out of work too long.
I picture these people showing up.
For a fact, they're talking with Clear Channel as we speak, and they'll be back on the air shortly.
How is it that a mere couple of years after we are the assholes and everyone in radio is being interviewed on our radio demise,
mm-hmm.
that we now have to fucking get on a TV show and talk about some other show's fuck up.
Mm-hmm.
I think I have a moral problem with this.
Hmm.
I think there's a bit of hypocrisy. If you recall, we sat there and just said, listen to these motherfuckers judging us.
Mm-hmm.
Who the fuck is a grease man to get on and talk about our career? Well, I think, I got in a little bit of trouble myself here.
Yeah.
You know, and we were talking about other jocks, Man Douche. He got on yapping about us.
Yep.
All of us, though, but all of them, by the way, said we would never work again.
Right.
We were blackballed.
Yeah.
Blackballed. Not the way, you know, Jimmy was that night in the car in the Saturn when you paid good money for what you thought was a girl, reached your hand down and got blackballed. Long way to go. Just a tad.
Needless to say.
Oh, you guys, please.
Needless to say. Thoughts and prayers.
A Frunkus, needless to say.
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Dude.
Oh, every Steve
that,
line.
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Had she died.
I mean, for the rest of their lives, these poor kids, people are going to be going, how did your parents die?
How did your parents
Everyone
die?
Everyone wants
right,
to.
Right, right.
Every day lately,
die?
We're having people ask, where did Frunkus come from? It was just a noise that
There's
Jimmy
no
I get a lot of emails. It's actually, it's an old Danish phrase. A lot of people remember the whole Frunk, like fan called Frunkus incident. It's not worth getting into.
Like, could you see her ask a question, Opie maybe starts answering, and I just cut in and go,
no, nothing's wrong. Just stay in the living room. I'll handle it.
No. So now you guys, have you ever done anything where you feared for the lives of your contestants?
No.
Grr.
How would you feel if you did do something like this?
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
It really is terrible. So,
terrible. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God. Please say that.
Well, good luck, bro.
Get a good luck, bro.
Someone's saying, remind everyone that radio is theater of the mind.
Theater of the swollen mind.
Mm-hmm.
Poor girl.
What the hell are we going to say?
I think what we stick to, Ope.
Mm-hmm.
I think condemning the show, not good. We will look silly.
Mm-hmm.
Because we are just as bad. And believe me, over the course of this program, over the years we have been doing it, I'm surprised we haven't racked up quite a body count. But we can comment on... nothing. No, we can comment on the fact that, you know, it was... things like this happen. It's very unexpected. You're there to entertain.
Right.
And then we just try to fit in as many show references as is humanly possible while babbling about nothing.
Or be just completely crass about it. Go, well, you know, I mean, we don't kill them. We just get them to fuck each other in the ass. High five. Or you just hear in the back. High five.
By the way, if you're just tuning into the Opie and Anthony show, we played the audio from the actual show.
Yeah.
That killed the woman. So listen to the replay today. Someone wants us to do the interview in wacky DJ voices. Oh, thank you, Alison. Thanks for having us on MSNBC.
Yeah, tragedy in Sacramento. We've been reporting this story along with you as journalists.
And just give her that angle.
Oh, that's the greatest.
It's terrible.
Jimmy Hatz from FBA, remind them that you're artists. All right, you ass.
Ah, that's a good one. We're artists.
One of the greatest TV moments ever. I actually told Bill O'Reilly that we're artists, and he went, you're
what?
You're what?
Yeah, you're what? You're artists?
Yes. You're sex peddlers. That's what you are.
Here's a painting I did. Look, one looking one way, one looking the other. Guy in the middle. What do you want from me?
No, her health won't allow it. People coming up with suggestions.
And now, I mean, they had one contest, and now she's dead.
She's dead. We can fit in a bunch of them. Oh, how long before they just cut us off?
Dude, who cares?
That's the beauty of it. Hello? Hello?
I say we talk about our eggnog drinking contest. I say we talk about the baby bird video. I say we, I say we not do the interview.
Very safe.
Yeah, we don't need to do the interview. Allison's like an old friend.
She is.
Because what's his name tries to get us on all the time.
You know, Allison, do you remember the time we shot a bottle rocket out of a woman's vagina? We made sure it was safe. We built a blast shield
right.
to protect her cunt.
And by that, we mean the daughter she brought with her.
By the way, that video is up on YouTube,
of
man.
Of course it is.
It is hilarious. It's back in the day when we were using a really old camera, but you could still see what was going on that day. That's how insane we were.
What you could get away with back then.
We
wow.
shot bottle rockets out of a girl's twat.
Yeah, we used those.
For 4th of July,
launcher.
When everyone else was off.
Shot it at a big, giant paper cutout of El Duque.
Yeah. It was target practice.
Yeah, got him right in the head.
How do they search for that video on YouTube? What's the name of that one? I want to direct them right to that one.
Bottle Rocket Twat.
You think?
I doubt it.
You think it'll be the only video?
No. It's never just one video when you put in something in the search. It doesn't show up, or there's 20.
I hear Max from Dallas. Max!
Hello again, boy.
Hello, Max.
When you're in a conversation with the lady, you should slip into one of Jimmy's vernaculars. You know, the...
Oh, my...
I
think what happened was tragic.
Tragic.
I'm just going to leak the whole time. Just take a long pee.
That would be good, yeah.
Too bad you can't be on the bowl shitting.
Getting that nice echoey sound.
Well, you know.
How hard did you fucking laugh?
Dude, I would never be able to do it. I would just laugh.
Be laughing, knowing it's coming. And just going, well, I think this should be taken very seriously. Is that echoey toilet sound?
Well, how about playing the parts of Opie and Anthony will be Bill and Steve.
Oh, that too.
Oh, wow. Nah, Elsa would know. She interviewed us.
Oh, she knows you guys.
Yeah, she knows us.
Damn it.
She did a whole piece on us once for some dumb show she was on. ABC or something back then.
I think she's still there.
No, it's MSNBC now.
Oh, okay. Well, I do a lot of impressions. I do Larry King. I
do them all. I do Steve Carr.
Let's say hi to Leroy in Baltimore. Leroy.
I'd like to plug.
Hey, morning, boys.
My band.
Hey.
My
How about doing nothing but answering questions with questions?
Answering questions with questions. Like, she says, how do you feel about what happened? Do you think it was justified that they were fired after this woman lost her life? So, should we be justified? Should we feel it was justified?
All right, we'll have some fun with that. I mean, we'll take it very seriously.
What time is it?
12:40.
Is it live or taped?
I think it's live.
Live?
Nah, she's not on at 12:40.
Yes, she is.
Oh, she is? You looked it up?
Yep.
Is she?
All right.
We'll do one of those.
Let's say hi to Brian in Ohio. Brian.
She died. Did she?
Boys. Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, I think you guys are blowing up your spot, man. You're telling all these great bits. Somebody's going to listen and not give you a call back.
All right, but it's fun for the radio right
now. Look, it's
moment.
Not like we were not going to give information in an interview.
Yeah, we're experts.
We're not going to curse.
We're experts at
no,
this.
There are ways of doing it and using words that we use on a daily basis.
Yeah, well, you know, your reputation precedes you enough. You don't need to give them ideas
That's
of what
true.
You're talking about.
It's not like we're going to do silent game.
All right.
Let's do silent
All right, brothers.
All right, we'll think about it. In the studio or outside the studio, we got Octane. Our boys from Philly.
Yes.
These guys, we go way back with them when we used to do road
nice.
Shows. The first time we went
yep.
down to Philly, they warmed up one of our road shows and just completely kicked ass.
Yep.
They were doing a lot of covers back then. But now we're discovering their originals are just as good.
Hell yeah.
If not better. How about that, if not better?
Played one out on the street.
Yeah, the song they played for us
rock.
Out on the street on the walkover, I don't understand why radio's not playing it like crazy.
Kicked ass.
YSP's playing it, right?
Oh, cool.
And who else? Any other stations? Can we maybe turn their mics on?
How does it go?
I saw the sign.
Can't get that out of my head. Dumb broad.
Are the mics on?
You got me?
Yeah.
MMR and Philly's playing it as well. There's some other stations scattered throughout the country that they're playing it too, but it's just they're starting to pick it up now, and I think a lot of it primarily to do with here. I know you guys definitely had a big impact. Since we did the show, we've been getting sales from all over the place, like places that had never...
Really?
Yeah, Canada, places on the other side of the country. I mean, everywhere, just... Very, very cool stuff.
Yeah, because that's how you got to make it these days, because rock radio is going away.
Stinks.
Yep, the internet. That's the way, man. That's the way.
Yeah.
And then you get these record companies that are saying to you, they're like, you know, if your records aren't in the stores, you're not going to do anything. I'm like, man, people are buying it over the internet anyway. They're not. Nobody goes to a store anymore.
And if you sucked ass, believe me, no one would have been buying it. It's to your guys' credit. It really sounded good. A lot of people heard it. And we're like, you know, where the hell can I get this?
Thank you.
Hey, are you guys on iTunes at all?
Yes, we are.
Okay,
absolutely.
That's what drove Tower Records out of business. So, I mean,
yep.
people just not going to the store, but they don't give a fuck about album artwork.
Mm-mm.
You know what I mean?
CD Baby as well. It's the same deal. They just go there and they buy and they don't even think twice about it.
I buy everything now online as far as music goes. I don't even buy the whole CD. You know what would have been the CD? Boom, download. It's there. It's on the iPod.
When I look at my CDs and my joint there, it looks so like, out of date.
It's
and
old.
Foreign now.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, God, this clunky thing?
It's like when
the
you,
fuck do
you
I have
look
this
at
for?
Your videotapes, like VCR tapes.
Right. The Tower Records where Jimmy did the signing.
Yeah.
For your HBO special.
It just closed, man.
It's creepy. It's in our neighborhood. It's just a massively,
closed
it's a
down.
Huge empty warehouse.
Don't
it
need
like
it anymore.
Now. It's There's not nothing. In this place.
I used to walk in there on the way home. I'd stop in because I knew they were closing. They were going out of business just to remember that signing day because they said that was the biggest signing that they ever had at
yep.
the store.
Yep.
We had a line all the way down the block. And that was a great day. So I kind of just go in there and go, oh, man, fuck, that was a fun day. And I know they're going to close. It's depressing.
You know, done.
Like, yeah.
No, we should have done. We should have done a bit where we had someone go into Tower Records every day to see what crap was no one was buying
like the last few days
yeah because they were
left.
Like I mean because by the end
Zamfir,
it was like 70%
of
off 75% off and still people were like I don't know man $2
Slim
for,
Whitman
$2 for Pat
the
Benatar's
box
greatest hits
yeah
a dollar I'd buy it
A buck.
You guys want to play something?
Absolutely.
Of course.
All right, get the plugs. It's Octane from Philly. MySpace, what are we plugging today? We want people to go and check you guys out on the internet.
Want them to know where they can get your stuff.
MySpace.com/OctaneRocks, and we got OctaneRocks.
Say that again. They turned your mic on halfway through the plug.
MySpace.com/OctaneRocks, and we got OctaneRocks.com. We're also going to be at Don Hill's tonight down at Spring and Greenwich in Greenwich Village.
Oh, cool.
You play in the city, too?
Yeah, oh, yeah, man.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Wherever they'll have us, we'll play.
What's that? Are they going to do the song they did that one day on the walkover?
It's really up to them.
I hope so.
That's great.
Yeah, I have to do that because we didn't get to hear that with, you know.
All you guys.
Yeah, you want
all the guys.
I think that's what you should start with. What do you say?
I'll say whatever you want, you guys. We can start with it. We can end with it. Whatever you want us to do, we're here to do.
Enemy, you want to start with that?
Absolutely.
All right, it's Octane from Philly. This is Enemy. They're great friends of the Opie and Anthony Show. Check it out.
Gotta take what I wanna waste, not another time. No time, no time to waste. I got a lot of anger inside. I'm wasting not another time. No time, no time to waste. My enemies are the closest friends I keep. Jesus warned me twice today. Each time my brain make love, not hate. Enemies, enemies are the closest friends I keep. Jesus warned me twice today. Each time my brain make love, not hate. I got a reason for being eyes open, seeing time. No time, no time to waste. Break down inside you, takes down your whole world, left on a tattered feet of a shattered time. No time, it's time to change. My enemies, enemies are the closest friends I keep. Jesus warned me twice today. Each time my brain make love, not hate. Enemies, enemies are the closest friends I keep. Jesus warned me twice today. Each time my brain make love, not hate. Ain't got no time.
Nice. That was awesome.
That's great.
Need a little more guitar, they're saying on the instant feedback. Just a little more.
Oh, you fixed the...
just slightly lower.
Are they self-mixing?
Who's self... Yeah. You guys are self-mixing?
I think it's an important note for you guys to know that the reason the other two guys showed up today is because last time Norton called them Pete Best.
And they're giving you the finger, Jimmy.
Fucking Jimmy.
Well, I'm glad they're here now. They got to be here.
It's all bent.
There you go.
Gotta be here. All bent.
What do you want to play next? We'll get another one out before we go to break here.
You want something a little more melodic or something kind of along the same lines? You want us to stretch a little bit for you?
What's melodic?
Really?
Whatever you want to
play. No, what is melodic?
Melodic's cool. Melodic's laid back, but very, very rock and roll, very deep, and with the big chorus and the big anthem, theater, blah, 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 blah.
Let me explain something to you. We're experts at dick jokes. You're experts at music in your band, so whatever you feel would work.
All right.
It's Octane.
This one's called Confessions. And gray. Time it slips away so fast, oh so fast. Each day seems to fade one to the next, like one big blur lost in a mess. I confess I like it messy.
Good.
Do you guys have CDs nice. With you?
That's it?
You have CDs with you?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, cool.
All right.
That's really good. I'll put that in my iPod.
I only have right one now. Problem. Why do we have to look at your ass while you're playing? Why couldn't you guys be facing us?
Oh, see, my problem is why didn't the rest of them turn around? We had a bunch of nice asses to look at.
We have this huge, like, window in front of us where we could see kind of where the studio audience sits. And that's where they set up because the whole band is here. And, you know, XM promised us for a couple of years they were going to build this studio. We gave up on that, building it out so we could actually be in the same room with the bands and stuff.
That'll happen.
And they set up in such a way where we get to see your ass, as you're saying. That's lovely. And the other thing, XM contact you guys? Are you on XM?
Nope.
What the?
The unsigned channel has not contacted us.
Do we have one anymore? I don't know if there's an unsigned channel anymore. But
that might be a reason.
That's well, no, but there's a channel that does play.
Of course there is.
XMU still not?
Huh?
XMU, right?
XMU, maybe?
They should be added immediately.
Still available.
Yeah, let's call Don Wicklin and get their songs on the radio, please, on XM in a nice little rotation.
Hell
they
yeah.
They deserve it. And what's the plug again?
The plug for the website?
Yeah.
OctaneRocks.com is our website. MySpace/OctaneRocks is the MySpace. And tonight we're going to be at Don Hills at Greenwich and Spring in New York City.
What time?
We go on at 9 o'clock, so 8:45.
All right, very good.
Supposed to lie.
We're going to take a break. More from Octane a little later on in the show.
Awesome. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Trekking through the Himalayas is quite exhausting. But the views are breathtaking. So tired. So famished. Great Scott. My Sherpa has collapsed. Ramon, fillet this Chinaman.
This is Dyer by the band.
Is Kiss? It is Kiss. I thought so. All right.
What song is it? I don't know.
I don't know the song, but it sounded like Kiss, and I'm like, that's why I asked.
All the Hell Breaking Loose.
Yeah. Okay. Good. I was right.
God damn, man. I'm into beginner Kiss. That's all I know. I don't know this other stuff by Kiss. I'll be honest with you. Well, they used to call it beginner dead. The deadheads would be like, oh, God.
Oh, those
You're at
people.
The beginner dead, like the basics. That's what I am with Kiss. I know the basics.
See, oh, I thought you meant like makeup. See, beginner Kiss to me is the makeup, the beginning. Like I'm into 70, like 73
I only know,
to 79.
And I was a huge Kiss fan growing up, but I only know the hits.
Yeah.
At this point. I wasn't interested enough to really get deep into the band.
I'd piss off deadheads and just go, you know, you into the dead or what song do you like or something? I'd be like, Touch of Grey, man.
Yeah.
Just rules. Oh, they would get all disgusted.
It's a good song.
Touch of Grey.
Touch of Grey is a great song.
That was the Charlie Daniels version of Devil Went Down to Georgia. If you were like into Southern rock in the 70s and you were into Charlie Daniels and Marshall Tucker and all that crap, and then you asked somebody, you know, what Charlie Daniels song they like, and it was like, oh, Devil Went Down to Georgia. You're like, you don't know anything they did before that? You're not a real fan.
I don't even know if I could name another Charlie Daniels song right now.
At this point in my life, I couldn't either.
Charlie
it was
Daniels
a million
band.
Years ago.
Wait, he had
a few hits.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I don't think I could even name one more song that
you
played on the radio.
I just only that one.
I wish I had a...
I'm going to cheat now. Dan's helping me cheat. But
take a look. You'll know. You fucking were at BAB. It's Charlie Daniels Central.
No, they weren't. They played...
Back before you. Maybe before
give me a
you.
Hit. These are just... Oh, go to the... Oh, you can't click on the Greatest Hits CD? That's where...
Yeah, Greatest Hits. That'd be where it is. There should be iTunes on this thing, so you just pop it up, and even though you can't, you know, play it, just kind of look at the names.
Fuck, I couldn't name another Charlie Daniels song.
I'm trying to think of one.
All right. Hurry up.
Hurry up.
All right.
Truckers are screaming right now.
God damn, I know, I tell you, if I could get through, fucking show doesn't even know another Charlie Daniels band song.
Super hits would do the
job. Super hits.
All different hits.
I know, I love that. A decade of hits, super hits, their greatest hits, the ultimate hit collection. Oh, man, how they get us to buy their shit.
Over and over again.
Long-haired country boy.
Ah, that was kind of one.
I don't know that one.
No.
Okay.
Well, give me the names, because I was a big fan.
None of these songs were radio hits, unless you live in the South. Uneasy Rider,
no.
Long-haired country boy.
I remember that one.
A little bit, because they needed a follow-up, right?
I remember that one.
The South's gonna do it.
Yeah, I remember that one.
A little bit, a little bit.
Yeah.
In America, still in Saigon.
Oh, jeez.
Drinking My Baby Goodbye. These are the ultimate hits? Hold on, hold on. Uneasy Rider.
Yeah.
What are you laughing
at? I'm just...
What happened?
It's pal talk.
All right.
Some hardware came out.
Let's see.
Hardware.
Oh, fuck.
I ruin everything.
She's so sexy. Simple Man.
Oh, that was kind of a hit.
Is that Leonard Skinner, his version of Simple Man?
Skinner, oh, right?
Yeah, okay, that's why it was a hit.
I think he just redid
Boy, Charlie
Man.
Dennis didn't have shit, did
nah,
he?
He stinks.
Well, this is the Essential Super Hit.
Oh, okay.
Let's go the Essential
Super Hit. Essential, that's the ones you need.
What was the last one?
Just Super Hit.
Super Hit. All right, so this is the ones you can live without.
This is essential.
Long hair, country boy. The South's gonna do it again. Same, pretty much the same lineup. This ain't no rag. It's a flag. Oh yeah, he tried to
shove that down our throats. Crap.
Southern boy. The Legend of Woolly Swamp.
I kind of remember that one. Bit.
Free Bird. Jesus,
what a douche Charlie Daniels is.
That's with the Leonard Skinner.
Biting off.
Fucking, the devil went down to iTunes and fucking just re-sang everything he downloaded, asshole.
The devil went down to a karaoke bar. Fuck, it was good, too.
It was still good.
All right. Give you a skid.
You skid it out.
You turned into it.
I was on my way. All right, well, that's not going to help me. Why don't we try another greatest hits? Jesus.
How many does he have?
Well, he's got a decade of hits. He's got the super hits.
Yeah,
he's got the
decade?
Essential super hits of the Charlie Daniels Band. The ultimate Charlie Daniels Band. The Essential Charlie Daniels Band.
And every one of these albums should have just The Devil Went Down and George on it.
He's got the live greatest hits. He's got the collection. He's got 25 favorite hymns and gospel greats. Ugh.
Yeah, that's when he got
Let's go with the decade of hits. I think that might be it. Right
I think
there.
The decade's the one you want. It narrows them down.
All right, let's see what this one is about. All right. Wow, same songs again. Jesus, same fucking CD. Just renaming it every couple of years.
Do we have long-haired country boy at all?
Probably.
Yeah. I want to hear something. I don't anything he does.
All right, give a little more Charlie
Daniels.
Some dude from Brooklyn's going to tell us what a popular Charlie Daniels song is. All right, Fred.
I'm telling you, man, you would know the song In America if you heard it.
In America?
It's a pretty rocking song, yeah.
You have In America?
I'm telling you, would know it.
When was that done, though?
It's on every greatest hits that he put out, so it's got
to
be.
Because if it's after Devil Went Down to Georgia, it doesn't matter.
Right after Devil Went Down to Georgia, right?
Yeah, see, that doesn't matter.
Right. Thank you, sir. This is In America?
He said you'll know it if you hear it.
It sounds like Devil Went Down to Georgia.
Exactly.
The fuck?
How will you know this unless you've been on a lynching?
Devil went down to Georgia.
Hey,
he was looking for a soul to steal.
This is... Yeah, I remember this, but it's...
I actually like this.
This was never on the fucking radio. And some people from Tennessee. Alright, how about long-haired country boy? This one might have been on the radio.
I like that.
This probably was.
Skinner.
Yeah, no kidding. That's the Skinner sound.
I know. Say
I'm no good. Oh, I've heard this, yeah.
Crazy
One of those drinking songs. Because I get stoned in the morning and I get drunk in the afternoon.
Kind of like my old blue tick hound. I like to lay around. Yeah, I remember this.
And I ain't got no money. God damn, I'm enjoying Charlie Daniels.
You like this?
Oh, listen to this. I ain't
asking no. Yeah, I know this one. This was on the radio. If I can't get it on my own.
Right? Nice. Fuck, am I a white hillbilly? Don't like the way I'm living. You just leave this
long-haired country boy alone. Half a Hulk face is calling. Oh, no. Half a Hulk nut is calling us. All right.
That's nice. Jimmy's getting turned on to some new music. song's, what, 30 years old?
Oh, is it old?
Yeah.
I'm enjoying this. Preacher man talking
on time. He's enough.
My chick likes country.
Charlie.
Yeah?
Sucks.
Yeah, I'm enjoying it. She, like, we'll drive around, and she has awful taste in music. My girlfriend's taste in music. Her ear should be cut off. She likes fucking, like, R&B. She loves R&B, which I hate.
Yeah.
And that and country. You want to talk about opposite ends of the spectrum, so, like, the country I'll take.
No.
You'll take the country?
Yeah.
Some country's all right.
See, that wasn't, like, considered country back when I was growing up. There was Southern rock.
Right.
And that was part of it. Even that song, like, Southern was rock a mellow Southern rock thing. And that included Charlie Daniels, Marshall Tucker. Did I mention Charlie Daniels?
What do they sing, Marshall
Leonard
Tucker?
Leonard Skinner. Marshall Tucker did, Let's not even go through it. You know what?
Answering.
Look up Marshall Tucker
popular?
On iTunes when you get home.
You really don't know Marshall Tucker Band?
No, I know the name. Sure,
they probably have songs you'd recognize before you would recognize a Charlie Daniels song.
Marshall Tucker Band had many more radio hits than the
What's
Charlie
one?
Daniels
I'm sure
band.
I've heard them. I just don't know by name.
Give us a Marshall Tucker hit.
All right. Because I bet for years would hear them in school, like the Marshall Tucker
Band.
Well,
let's go with the first 30 years. Jesus.
Oh, no.
Yeah, exactly.
First 30 years.
Exactly.
Bobble, bobble, bang, bang,
bang.
You might remember this one.
Can't you see?
Blue moon.
Yeah, Can't You See was a huge hit on the radio.
Yeah, Can't You See was a big one.
Give us a little Can't You See there, Bill. What else? Heard It in a Love Song was big on the radio.
Oh, the live version. That probably goes on for an hour and a half.
Let's see. There's not many others, actually, now that I'm looking at the list here.
Another band with a flute. But it was, you know, Southern rock with a flute.
Right, right.
One of their mellower.
A flute.
Yeah.
Gets off the tour bus with his little flute case.
Jesus. I gotta haul this. Where's my roadie?
Smuggles his own instrument in his asshole.
Probably put it down his pants leg, hoping that the groupies would think it's just a big cock.
The obligatory guitar lead before the vocals come in. They'd give a little riff.
No one has attention for this anymore. Back in the day, kids.
This was like any other
attention span where we would listen to the guitar solo for a while.
This is like any other type of music, hair band music, everything. It had its moment, and then there were a bunch of people that kind of just kind of gonna check a freight train. Picked up the sound. Down at the station,
I don't care. I'm just staring at Jimmy. You don't know the song, do you?
I don't know, but I like it.
Wow.
I like this stuff.
This has been played on the radio.
I'm sure I've heard it.
Ad nauseum.
That's good
ad nauseum.
I always say ad nauseum, but it's ad.
Chorus. Can't you
see? Oh, yeah. Oh, can't you see? What the ad for, Lord? Sounds like Creedence. Bramp, bramp. They were popular, right? Marched for years.
And is flute guy done? What happened to flute
done.
Guy?
At that point, he better pick up something else or he's going to be out of work.
Triangle.
Pick up something, flute guy.
What do you do if you're flute guy? You do your part. You're on stage. Now what?
You just have to stand look there. You got to stand there and tap your foot.
But how do you look busy?
Rock your head back and forth with your cowboy hat on.
Do you run and fill up everyone's Jack Daniels?
Yeah. you run errands.
You run errands.
He's like the Club Soda Kenny for the band. He can just play a little flute and then he runs off and gets some fruit.
You think flute guy just walks off?
Gets a smoothie. I hope so. He'd look awkward just standing there.
What the fuck does flute guy do?
I've heard this.
The tail end of Southern rock was bands like Molly Hatchet.
Yeah.
Who started picking up on things like that and had their... and everyone had a... Had a whistle in the song.
A little whistle action?
Yeah.
Boy, did my flute joke bomb, by the way.
Oh, did it?
Wow.
Which one? What happened?
Not only, it didn't get a laugh. No one responded that a person had talked.
Oh, no. Are you kidding?
I was okay. You said he was coming off the tour bus. I said he smuggles his own instrument in his asshole.
That's funny. We didn't hear it.
I was
sorry.
Oh, it's hopefully don't be. I just fired
great visual.
I'm sorry. I just got insecure.
And walking off a tour bus with a flute in his ass would be funny.
That's right.
And speaking of shoving things up your ass, let's say hi to Buck Angel.
Ah, what a segue, Opie.
Thank you. Buck Angel on the Opie and Anthony Show. What's up, Buck?
Hey, nothing. How's it going?
Wow. Well, our pal Jimmy Norton ran into you at the porn convention out there in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Hope he didn't run into him.
And
nothing.
And then he brought back pictures of you, and I got to be honest, never heard of you, never seen a picture of you before, but we're beyond fascinated.
Steve came running in all giddy.
Oh, yeah, no kidding.
I was summoned.
Don't lie. You have summoned. Videos in your house. I'm sure you have one of my videos under your bed somewhere.
Yeah. I'd love to see one now, to be honest with you. I had heard of you, but I've never seen any of your stuff. And I was the little small guy, and Steve is the guy next to me that we were talking about doing films.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Yeah. Like he's hasn't done a few. How many films you done, sir?
I've done 7 films.
7 films. That's it.
And basically,
yeah, not very many. I'm actually very picky about what I do, because everyone wants to put me in all their videos. I want to have total control over what I do.
No,
I know you guys probably think I'm a freak, but I'm not really a freak, and that's why I try to maintain control over.
No, because you know when I read The Man with a Pussy, the first word that comes to my mind is not freak.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
That's cool. I appreciate that.
Now, we've seen the photographs. I've never seen a movie, but we've seen the photographs.
Well, I'll have to send you guys a movie then, and then you can review it and tell me what you think.
Yeah, we'll do that right away. Now, the pictures of you, just to describe to the listeners, because maybe they didn't hear us talking about you the other day, you look like a biker dude, no hair, like just rocking the skull.
Right.
Lots of tattoos.
Yeah.
And you're missing a penis.
I'm missing a penis, yes, but I enjoy my pussy. That's the most important thing.
See, it's a complete muscular man's body.
Yes,
and
I work out very hard.
Man's face, you would think, you know, if this guy pulled up on a Harley, he's another biker guy.
The last thing you're thinking is this guy has a pussy.
Right. And he's got a pussy.
Right.
And now, what are you exactly? What were you born? How did you get this way?
Well, I was born female, and I had a sex change. I'm a female-to-male transsexual. I'm actually the opposite of, I'm sure you know, she-males, which are basically chicks with dicks.
Jimmy does.
I'm the opposite of that. I was born a female. I had a sex change to a man.
What do they do to make it? I mean, like, because, I mean, some people say that if you start with a penis, you turn it into a vagina. I mean, that makes you a silly goose. I mean, did you start, like, how did they make it? It's like just like a vagina with a big clit. Do they stretch your clit a little bit?
No. It's all natural. I have had no surgery from the waist down.
Oh, cool. You do have a very nice vagina, if I may.
So thank you. I appreciate that. I work hard at that.
Did you feel like you were a guy growing up? Like, I don't get this.
Help me out here. You know, come on, man. You've seen many stories on Discovery Channel or wherever about people who just always feel like they're in the wrong body. I mean, it's pretty out there now. It's not something like, you know, in the closet anymore. I've always felt like I was a guy growing
up. Yeah, we saw
like
a picture.
Tomboy. Sorry?
We saw a picture of you as a woman.
Right.
And how old were you living completely as a woman?
Oh, I was in my 20s before I decided to have a sex change, and I was actually a female model. I was doing modeling as a woman, which was very difficult for me to do because I felt like I was a guy, and it was, you know, putting makeup on my face and going, you know, to Europe and doing fashion shows and all that.
I got
to
tell you, man, your face as a woman, yeah. Right on, man.
You're very pretty.
I can't believe you'd want to, you know, change the whole
look around.
Go from that to biker dude.
Because well, see,
you had a beautiful face. I mean, what I see in your modeling picture, your old modeling picture, you kind of have like manly hands.
Yeah, I was because I was a manly
man
woman. You know, I didn't even have a very feminine body, but. Doesn't that make you think that I was that desperate to have a sex change? If I was a good-looking female, why would I go and change myself to this kind of looking guy?
So, you're a big clit.
Yeah, I had a big clit too. So
yeah.
It was, you know, the hormones helped that a little bit.
No, but your face is a woman, beautiful. As a guy, whatever. People are into that. So what can I tell you? You're a biker dude now.
I have a big fan base of people. Most of my fan base happens to be men, by the way, gay men. But I do have a pretty large women fan base.
Gay men.
But you grow the beard and everything, man.
Yeah.
It's so weird to know that you start as that and now you're a biker dude with a beard.
A biker dude.
And how do they get your chest to look manly? Like, do they just suck out your boobs?
No, they didn't because I didn't have most boobs are like fat and I didn't have big boobs. They just did a really good surgery and I work out very hard in the gym and this is all natural.
You look like you have a guy's chest. You wouldn't look at it closely and go, well, I could see the hint of him being a female in a past life.
Now, you're attracted to guys, girls, gay men, or gay women?
All of the above.
Everything.
I like that.
Why should I limit myself?
Ah, there you go.
If it has genitals, you'll fuck it.
Exactly.
What about animals?
No. No animals and kids. We don't go there.
And the obvious question, so you go from a woman to a man, why not get the penis?
Because, and don't think I didn't want to have one, but the thing is the surgery is horrific. It doesn't work. I don't want to have a dick that hangs between my legs and doesn't get a hard on. What's the point of having one?
Well, how do they make a dick?
Pumps.
It's really unbelievable, the surgery. They, like, rip part of your arm off and take tendons out and take skin grafts, and they mold it into this penis that doesn't particularly look very nice for me. Some guys like me want to get it because they feel like they need to have the penis to be a man. I don't particularly think I need to have a penis that bad to be a man. You know, I have, like, 7 dildos in my drawer. And it stays hard all night, you know? And I'm married to a woman, and she's totally happy, and I don't have any issues with it.
Wow. You're married?
Yeah, I'm married. Mm-hmm.
Did not know that.
Legally?
Legally, I am legally a male. Yes, I had a legal sex change. I had my birth certificate changed, my passport changed, all my documents changed.
Wow. But you can pee standing up?
I can pee standing up. Yes, I can.
Okay. That's kind of important, you know, because you go into the bathroom.
I know guys that go, you know, genetic guys that go in the bathroom and go in the stall and sit down. I mean, you know, sometimes you want to sit down because you're tired or whatever.
Do you know how popular you'd be in prison?
You know what? They would actually stick me in the woman's prison because of my genitals. Even though I am legally a man, they would stick me in a woman's prison.
You'd
which I would
be fucked out
popular.
In the first week.
I wouldn't want to go to the men's prison. I think it'd be pretty scary.
Like, hey, I'll spot you lifting weights. Hey, he's fucking me. Jesus Christ. That is something because I've heard about the female to male and seen a few of them, but never seen the genitalia.
Mm-hmm.
And never saw somebody who is actually an attractive woman turn into a guy that you would see walking down the street and wouldn't give a second look at because it's just another guy walking down the street.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's what makes my change so much more drastic for people is, like, why the hell would you go from this hot woman to this ugly guy? And it's like, because it was a desperate situation for me. I was not happy living as a woman. It just was really not a good situation.
Did you just love the cock as a woman?
Actually, no. You know, I was probably considered a lesbian as a woman. I was much more into men as a woman. I mean, into women as a woman. Now
see,
I'm woman.
He's even confused.
You're into women as a woman.
I fuck everything now. I don't even know what gender.
What type
is
of guys like? I don't get. What type of guy wants to fuck you?
Yeah, that's a good question, actually.
Thank you.
Mostly it's gay men, and I think because they maybe at some point in their life wanted to try to fuck a vagina, but they're not attracted to women. So, you know, basically what it is now is I'm a guy with 2 holes. I just, you know, it's just a hole. That's all it is.
That would kind of be like Scarlett Johansson has a dick.
Oh, please, go ahead.
Would you fuck her in the ass?
Yes.
Yeah, you would. Don't lie.
I'd let her fuck me.
Now, females are so popular because they're hot. I mean, some of those girls are amazing. You would never know in a million years that they had a cock between their legs.
I have 2 questions for you. One, there was one tranny that was with him that I wanted to get to walk the carpet because I've never seen it. Who were some of the transsexuals that were standing over in that area with you?
Oh, yeah, that was Wendy Williams, who I've done a movie with. So we did a totally mind fuck movie where we fuck each other, and you know, it's like from the waist up men and women, and then from the waist down it's like, what the hell's going on? And then the other girl was Holly. She was, both of those girls were also nominated for the Avian Award like I was.
Now, which one looked really like, really, there was one that looked nothing like a woman.
I don't even go there with me. I'm not answering that question.
Okay, let's say, how about this one? There was one who was blonde hair, but kind of rugged looking. She looked kind of rugged.
Holly, the one with the huge boobs. I mean, her boobs were like out of control.
No. This girl had a very a pink top, Steve is saying.
I think that's Wendy Williams.
Maybe.
All right.
Yeah.
Hey, Buck, Shane from Tennessee wants to know if you can get pregnant still.
Yeah, everyone always asks me that question. Nope, because I have been taking testosterone for 15 years, so it shut everything down. I don't get my period anymore.
Do you still have... We were wondering that, too, because we were seeing this man's body, like the upper chest and the face, and Anthony pointed out there are ovaries
inside.
There's got to be ovaries in there and a womb.
Yeah, exactly.
But they're all, you know, it's like a haunted house.
It's totally a haunted house. It's all like spider webs and everything.
Yeah, they're dried up like raisins and
nothing.
Exactly. They spunk up. Yeah,
no eggs coming
out of
that.
Congratulations. The AVN 2007 Transsexual Performer of the Year, by the way.
You won?
Was it tough competition? Or?
Well, I mean, come on. I'm the only guy in the industry at this point. But you know what? I was against all those girls, and you know they were so pissed off when I won. I mean, this is historical. There's never been a guy ever in the history of the AVN Awards to win this award. So
catty bitches.
Totally. Ah. They're all pissed.
And did you shove the award right up your pussy? Right up your man pussy?
Now that would have been a show.
With that award.
where can people? It's really weird to look at Buck Angel because it's odd to see a vagina on a guy. Like chicks with dicks. I mean, who hasn't seen those in movies only, of course. Where can people see one of your flicks if people want to see your vagina being pounded?
Buckangel.com. You can go there and download some of my movie clips.
Okay.
Yeah.
Buckangel.com.
But, you know, there was one time when it wasn't normal for you to see, you know, chicks with dicks. And basically that's what I'm doing now. I'm opening the door to make this into a genre of porn.
Well, thank God.
It was necessary.
That's good. Nowadays, chicks with dicks, passe. Disney's putting out movies with chicks with dicks.
Exactly, yeah.
So you're turning a whole nother corner here, and it's guys with pussies.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Wow. And I'm the leader of the pack.
That's fantastic.
My claim to fame.
Well, yeah. I'll be honest. I wanted to hate you, but you're all right. Buck Angel's
Why'd you want to hate the guy?
Yeah, Buck's very interesting.
Yeah,
I'm a nice guy. Everyone wants to wreck me.
Sounds like a nice enough guy.
Creepy.
You know, you invite him over, a few beers, you watch the game, and then you could fuck him.
He is like, what a great friend he'd be to have.
Yeah. Just hanging out.
How many of your guy friends, like, all of a sudden find out about shit and then just kind of, like, casually ask, can you keep a secret?
Dude, they all know because I'm so out there, you know. I'm actually pretty famous, to be honest with you. So everyone knows that I am a man with a pussy. It's not something I hide anymore. I can't really hide it.
How great would it be to see you strip search in an airport by some guy who has no idea?
I know. I think about that all the time. I'm like, oh, God, please let their thing go off so they can search me. Because, you know, they're going to freak the fuck out.
Something metal up there. Where's your cock, sir?
Hey, Coke Logic from Whackbag, he wants to do a new contest. Fuck Buck for a week.
For a week?
No, for a week. It's a little... Are you in L.A.?
Actually, no. I moved out of the country. I live in the Yucatan in Mexico.
No, I don't blame you.
Really?
Yeah, the country's fucked up. I'm out of there.
Really? You know, United States, you know what you're talking about?
Yeah, the United States. The government is totally fucked up. So they're really anti-porn, and they're going, you know.
The guy with a pussy is telling us the government's fucked up.
Yeah.
I just want to make sure that sank in with everybody.
Right.
All right. Well, buckangel.com, and hopefully people will check it out, because I've never seen one of your flicks. I've seen just about everything, but I've never seen that. So I make.
Well,
I'll
get you guys some movies, and maybe next time. You guys are in New York, yeah?
Yeah.
Maybe next time I get to New York, I can come by the studio or something.
Well I hear V for Vagina just got rave reviews by everybody.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Oh right, I like that. Actually, that's a film I did with all females. Like I'll do a film with all guys, and then I'll do a film with all women, and then I'll do a film kind of mix it all up with guys and girls. You know,
guys go ahead, fucking sucking.
Exactly.
Just a little bit of everything. All right, Buck. Well, thanks for spending a few minutes with us.
All right.
Today. We've enlightened a few people, I believe.
I want to see Buck Angel in studio, though, because I want to see if we can get a listener who is obviously clean and Buck to lick Buck's vagina.
Oh, yeah. That sounds like a good deal. Let's check. Let's do it.
To go down on Buck.
Yeah.
That's a great idea. Let's do it.
I completely think that
would
be...
I think you'll find somebody.
Because, you know, I mean, obviously you're living like a man. You've had these surgeries, hormone treatments and stuff. But technically, there is a vagina, a womb, ovaries, even though they're not, you know, useful.
Right.
So, Opie, I put the question to you. Is it gay if you have sex with Buck?
I think it's gay.
It's gay, dude.
Buck's saying it's gay.
See, all of a sudden, you feel the razor stubble.
Gay. I'm not talking about kissing or anything like that.
I understand.
Now you're talking something that means stuff.
How about, you know, your face is
if
side
you lick
to
my
side.
Pussy, and, you're gay, dude.
Yeah.
No, see, I disagree because I like a pussy like yours. Like, I like a meaty one. Like, I only saw a couple of photos of yours.
You're telling a gentleman you like his pussy.
Yes. Look, no disrespect, sir, but I happen to think your pussy is fantastic. I like one, that like a roast beefy, big meaty clit. That's just what makes me happy.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that.
Hey, look at that. You
like bodybuilder chicks, I like their pussies are fucking
really?
Just, yeah, they're just meat.
God. Are you kidding?
No, I love that.
Bodybuilder
chicks? But once it goes too far, I don't like it. Like if the clit's too big, it's gross to me. But I like there's a certain level of clit can go to that I love.
Yeah, it becomes a
cock. Yeah, some of those bodybuilder girls have way bigger clits than I do. I mean, they're actually way more manly than I am, if you ask me.
You have hair on your ass and stuff?
Yeah, but I shave it. It's gross. I hate that.
Hey, do you get, like, a normal orgasm? Like a clit orgasm?
Actually, yeah, my orgasm's changed after taking hormones, for sure. I mean, it's definitely much more intense. I used to be able to have, like, you know, 6 orgasms. Now I have 1 and go to sleep. So I guess that makes me a guy.
Oh, well, you're officially a guy. Yeah.
Totally.
All right, Miss Angel.
Yes, Mr. Buck Angel.
Mister, that's me. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Buck, right, Buck, Buck, what was your name as a girl? What name were you?
Susan. I was born as Susan, so you guys haven't seen it. You just saw a couple before pictures of me.
Yeah, I got the before pictures.
They're hanging around,
just spin that one around. Let's take a look.
They're hanging around somewhere.
You're kind of like, you look like an 80s chick.
Yeah, I was totally 80s.
You got definitely. Like the short blonde hair.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Perfect face.
Your leather
face
jacket's open a little. You were a small-breasted woman.
Yep, exactly.
With the manly hands. There was a little man in you back
pussy.
Then. That's a big man's hand.
Yeah.
That's why I got confused. I'm like, did he start out as a woman?
Now, did you have sex with men back then?
No, I was definitely much more into women.
Not at all?
If I got fucked up on coke and, you know, drinking, then I might fuck anything. But when I was aware of what was going on, I mostly just fucked women.
I would just like to know if there's a guy out there that had sex with you as a woman that can now look at you and go, oh, my God, I fucked him.
I know. I thought about that, too. Like, no, I think that they would probably throw up if they thought about that. So.
You never had any kids, right?
Oh, no, no kids. I'm actually going to probably have a hysterectomy here soon because, like you said, it's all haunted house down there.
Really?
Get rid of it, yeah.
It's going to have it yanked out like an old tooth.
Yank it out.
Tie a string around it and around the doorknob and just slam it shut.
Wow. That's pretty wild, man. That's all right.
Maybe we'll see you in New York then.
Hey, how much can
all
you,
right, man.
How much can you bench?
300.
Holy shit.
Can you really?
Oh, yeah. Let's have a benching.
Science
let's have a benching
is fucked up. He started as a woman and now he's benching 300.
Benching 3
dude,
pills.
I work my ass off, man. I go to
Steve,
the
Steve, can you bench 300 right now? Be honest.
Right now? No, probably not.
Steve, the biggest guy in the organization, and he's in very good shape. He's at the gym all the time. He can't bench 300.
Well, you know,
Buck Angel started life as a dainty female, except for the man hands. Now benching 300 pounds.
Yeah. What do you think of that, Steve?
Enough with science.
Why don't you get your dick cut off, you asshole?
All right, fine.
Get your dick cut. Yeah, right.
Get a vagina.
Science is officially scary.
It's all about that testosterone. Start shooting testosterone.
Yeah. But you still have to take drugs like that?
Oh, yeah. I have to shoot myself like every 2 weeks. And it's not really a lot of testosterone, but you know, it's enough to make me look like this.
If you stop, you grow tits back and
No, because I had them all cut off, so it's not going to happen. But if I stopped, if I didn't have a hysterectomy, I would probably get my period again, and I probably could get pregnant. And that's a whole other genre of porn.
That would be amazing in the delivery room.
That would be
confused
sick.
Doctors just looking at your manly face.
Like watching
baby
an alien
comes out.
Autopsy.
No kidding. What about the C word, sir? Does that bother you?
Cunt?
Most women hate the C word.
The cunt word?
Yeah, but you're a man now.
Yeah, I'm a man. No, I love that word.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, throw it around.
Throw it around.
I love it.
Like
yeah.
The,
like,
right?
You know, when they're pounding me and like, fuck your cunt, and I love that.
Right.
Yeah.
All right.
We're on satellite radio, right?
Of course.
Oh, yeah.
This is not terrestrial radio. This would have been a problem.
It's all beep, beep, beep.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, terrestrial radio took our penises as well, sir. So we got something in common.
Exactly.
All right, Buck Angel.
All right, guys.
Anything else for Buck? I think we covered all the bases.
Very enjoyable.
Yeah.
Cool.
Are you tight?
Am I tight? Nah, sometimes. It depends if I haven't been pounded for a while, then, you know, it kind of goes fast.
Do you like butt sex?
No, actually, I can't. I've been trying because, you know, everyone writes me, come on, dude, I want to see you get pounded in the ass and the pussy. But, you know, it's hard to get something up your ass. You have to practice a lot.
Steve?
So.
Yeah, he's right.
You know what I'm talking about.
Buck said I had the daddy look, and I'm still not sure what that means.
Daddy?
Yeah, when we interviewed him in Vegas, he said I had a daddy look, and I'm still a little bit perplexed as to what that means.
What does that mean, Buck?
Yeah, that's a compliment, actually. It's just kind of very handsome, you know, the mustache and the hair and, you know, just...
It's
like a good-looking guy. I was kind of hitting on you, but you didn't get it, so...
Oh, Steve, you miss all the signs.
You missed it, man. You had
I saw the signs.
No, I was petrified.
Was there a reason you hit on Steve?
A little
of that Gaydar was popping up.
The Gaydar, there you go. Totally.
Gaydar detector went off like a car doing 120.
Oh, shit, I'm speeding. No.
It's not to.
All right, Buck, I think we've done as much as we can until we get you in studio.
Right, all right.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for having me on. I appreciate it, you guys.
Bye, right, Buck Angel.
Hey, what's the big plug as you go?
All right, it's all about checking out buckangel.com. You can see everything, buy my movies, and email me dirty, nasty letters.
Oh, well, our listeners can do that.
All right, I'll talk to you guys later.
If you like cock pictures.
All right.
Take it easy there, Buck.
Steve, everyone asking for a before and after picture for the website.
Yep.
We'll do that. It'll be up on opiananthony.com.
I have to leave, guys. I have to go to Chicago.
No. It's not so.
It's not so.
Oh, but
say goodnight, Gracie.
Goodnight, Gracie.
What about the DD stuff?
I have to be on a plane.
DD.
What time's your plane?
I have to leave by 11:30. I have to finish packing, too.
Packing. Why didn't you do it last night?
I did a lot of it last night, but I couldn't finish it because I had laundry.
How long are you going to be gone?
Till Sunday.
Oh, did you take enough underwear?
I did.
One pair. Slacks. Did you bring slacks for your show?
I brought one pair of underpants and I brought one pair of slacks.
Slacks.
Ticket sales are good, right?
For I don't know. I haven't
Van
checked.
Van Heusen shirt.
Well, you're not really plugging it, so I'm assuming you're doing all right.
I know. I just forget to plug it.
All three zanies. Not one or two. All three zanies in Chicago. Jimmy Norton, people. Jimmy Norton.
I want to work on my HBO special. So I got to do an hour. So that's what I'm going out and doing now. All these gigs I'm doing are just to work this hour out. It has to be worked out.
That's got to be the most fucked up thing for a comic. Hey, we need an hour. It's like, because I know a lot of comics started out and, you know, starting out and stuff, and it's like, oh, I hope I get 3 minutes.
Yeah.
I need 3 solid minutes of material. Dude, an hour.
You got way more than an hour. You're fine.
Yeah, but I want to do stuff people haven't seen. Bit. You know,
just got to work it out a little bit. Jimmy's going to be fine.
My funny voices and faces.
Chicago, to the O&A Pest in the Chicago area. I have a feeling when you come back on the radio, we're going to hear stories of guys coming, long distances to see you.
I hope so.
Absolutely. So it's Jim Norton at Zany's. Three locations in Chicago. How do they figure out which date is which?
Well, tonight is downtown Chicago. Thursday night is the downtown small room. I guess the
Hold on. You know what? Sorry. Keep it at that.
Okay.
Tonight, Jim Norton, downtown Zany's. If you can't make tonight's show, then what? What's the website?
Friday. Zany's.
All right. This is going to confuse people. But tonight is downtown Zany's. St. Charles is Friday. And Vernon Hills is Saturday. Okay.
Thursday, Friday, Saturday. All right, boys, I'll see you.
And Jimmy's going to be on Steve Dahl tomorrow afternoon on WCKG.
CKG. Yes.
Will you guys start supporting the fucking commercial radio stations, please?
Please.
Just a little bit.
Cack second.
Bye, just guys. A little bit. Will you help us out? Thanks,
Take
Jimmy.
Take it easy, Jimmy. Stay warm in Chicago.
Have a good flight, and we'll continue in just a bit.
He's all bunk.
Hey, you're listening to the Opie and Anthony Show.
Yep. Okay.
All right. I think we're going to get another song from Octane in a few minutes here.
Nice.
Our pals from Philly. The boys are asking if we could still weigh E-Rock.
They got $100.
Still
want to
weigh him? Well, you gave $100, right, last week?
I believe I did. What, was it $100?
$100.
Wow. And you guys all guess what he's going to be down to?
Been drunk.
Yeah, we all picked out of a hat.
All right, he gained 19 pounds over the holiday. He was 200. He was up to 219. We're like, you're a fat fuck. You shouldn't be this fat. Mm-hmm. So we basically put the pressure on him to lose some weight. So now we're paying attention to what he's looking like and what he's eating, and we're weighing him on a weekly basis. Unfortunately, the bit now sucks because the first weigh-in, he lost 2 to 3 pounds, right?
Yeah, but that could have just been like morning. He didn't eat anything. It was.
When did we weigh him last Thursday? Last Thursday?
Officially, we did a preliminary. We did another one Monday.
Oh, yeah, we surprised him on Monday, and what was he down to?
216.
216, right, E-Rock?
216.
See, he looks thinner, and he's wearing black to make himself look thinner. He's very conscious of his weight gain now, unfortunately.
Yeah.
We got $100 up for grabs.
Did you have another marshmallow, Sam? He loves his marshmallows. I like him in cocoa, the mini ones.
Just don't grab them. Right,
you can't fucking stop. Every time he comes into the studio now, he grabs the chubby bunny marshmallows and just like starts devouring them.
It's open and it's right there.
Sam, let me tell you a little something.
Oh, you're entitled to some sweets.
You have the same body type that I used to have. But now that I'm 30, my metabolism has changed to the point I can't just grab at marshmallows anymore.
Marshmallows.
Well, I only got a few years left till I'm 30, so.
Yeah, so enjoy them while you can.
Yeah. So enjoy it, because your metabolism is still very very up there, or whatever.
It's like a little kid.
Yeah.
Marshmallows, where are the cookies?
We hired kids around here.
I know, we hired a bunch of fucking kids.
Half these guys weren't even, like, born when we started together.
Started? Jesus Christ. Born, like, when we got fired. Children. I know. They're 3 years old, 4 years old.
Well, honestly, let's figure this out. How old are you, Sam?
I'm 23.
23. So when Anthony and I started back in 94, that's a little over 12 years ago, you were 11 years old.
Yeah, oh, my God. He was 11. Oh, eating little marshmallows.
Back then, it was the mini marshmallows.
Mini marshmallows.
That's where the marshmallow habit started.
He had like one
probably
of those
for good grades.
Play
mommy,
school.
Mommy made cocoa with marshmallows for him.
He had a play school camera that couldn't break. Big heavy plastic thing.
A Mr. Microphone and a plastic camera.
Me want to do radio.
Okay, he's 11, not retarded.
All right, so someone set up this this bit here. We got $100. You guys all guess what E-Rock would weigh, obviously. It's as easy as that? Okay, yep. Good. Than is handing me the weights. People are playing at home and on Pal Talk and on the instant feedback. E-Rock. Okay, wow. All right, so Monday, E-Rock weighed 216 pounds. Than says he didn't lose another pound this week. He's still at 216. Travis says 214.
Oh, wow. He went with the dropping of a couple of pounds.
Sam, of course Sam said that he would gain a pound. Sam says 217.
Just hoping for
Danny,
the worst.
He lost another pound. I think that's a safe bet right there. I'm going to go with Danny on this.
Losing 1 pound?
Yeah, 1 pound.
I might go with Travis with two.
Two?
Travis, did you give him your AIDS? Is that, and he dropped a few?
Derek says that he gained 2 pounds back since Monday.
Mm.
And Bill says 213, so that means he lost 3 pounds.
Bill asks, what planet is he being weighed on? Because it's fucking Bill.
He doesn't even get it.
No.
That's the scary part.
He's just petrified now of hitting the wrong button. That's what we get out of Bill now. Utter and pure fear.
He just stared blankly at you. Voted that's most likely to kill great. Us. Congratulations,
yep.
Bill.
I know. Congrats for a second year running.
Second year running, yes.
We're only a few days in to this year.
The guy most likely to go postal.
Go postal and kill the entire staff.
All right, E-Rock, if you will, it's time to weigh you once again here.
Step up on the scale.
This bit.
I wish we had some wacky sound effects of springs going boing. Wouldn't that be funny?
How about a drum roll? The morning rave doesn't need it anymore.
I don't have to use that one.
Do you want it?
No, I could give a shit about a drum roll.
This is called wasting time, you idiots. All right, let's go, E-Rock.
He steps up on the scale.
Sam's got his camera.
Come on.
Oh, no. Oh, wait, we got a little
bongo
drum roll going there. And
look, E-Rock ran to the mic. That means he lost another pound.
Look how happy. Look, he's smiling. He's happy. Someone punch him.
Okay.
Okay.
E-Rock?
214.4. 214.4. It looks like Travis.
Yes, you got to go down on that. So it's 214.
Does Travis win money? Again?
Travis wins $100.
This motherfucker is now like a wealthy guy. He won 5 G's.
All right, we'll weigh you next Thursday there, E-Rock. So far, so good.
Wow.
That was really exciting.
That'll buy you another sweater when you have to go fucking up to the North Pole to visit your friends.
Octane is applauding. This is what we have to do.
Yes, what?
I have to leave early.
Oh.
I'm looking at houses. I'm trying to, like...
Are you going to try to be domesticated and civilized? And
you know what? I was looking around my place the other day because I had to move back into the shithole. And I swear to God, the other morning I'm thinking, I lived better in college when I was living in a frat house.
Than you live now in this apartment.
Than I live right now. Yeah.
You live in a flooded out apartment.
Yeah, the downstairs is off limits.
Because of mold?
I guess. I'm not taking a chance.
So you just live upstairs now?
Yeah.
And
the people upstairs don't have a rug, so I listen to them and their cats when they come home at 1 in the morning.
Homeless guy out your bedroom window.
Yep. That pees into the air conditioner.
Yeah, it pisses into your AC.
So you turn that on, you smell urine. It's just wonderful. So I gotta go find a house today. I'm going to try at least. Should we do line of the day, and then we're going to have Octane play us out? No line of the day today?
Because E-Rock pulls it, so.
All right, that's
fine. And he was busy in a bunny suit.
All right, fuck line of the day. Gives a shit.
I was hoping to win today.
What was your line?
I don't even.
Who had a good line today?
Everybody.
Oh.
Wow, Dan. You're a go-getter. You're going to go places.
Fat guy from Chicago. Opie, whatever happens to throwing your $5,000 out of a helicopter? I said I want to go to Chicago, and then Tom Chisano's like, hey, that's not what you said on the air the first time. Got to keep it legal. You said postcards. You said postcards.
Keep it legal.
So we have to have a meeting and figure it out. I figured, you know, throw Chicago a bone.
Why can't some crybaby cities just take it? And we said, yeah, we'll take postcards, and then decide, you know something? Fuck it. We're going to do Chicago. Why does it have to be a legality thing?
Legal, huh?
Enough. If it was up to me, I'd say we go to fucking Buffalo and congratulate them for the great ratings they gave us.
No kidding.
Thank you, Buffalo.
Well,
yeah. Now we can just go continue forgetting about them.
All right, Paul from Florida.
Seems to do us best when we just leave the cities alone.
Paul C. from Florida. I'm going to show you something here.
Uh-huh.
Weigh the fat fuck staff member equals hack bit. You cunts won't even read this because you know it's true.
Oh, yeah, okay.
All right.
That's right.
Wow.
I'm just waiting for the world to stop now.
Paradox.
Yeah. I'm waiting for like,
it is
the
a paradox because he
stop,
read it.
To stop shining.
And he said we weren't going to read it, so now that you did, wow, that's tough.
What happened?
What a dick.
What happens?
Shut up.
How did Jay Moore screw you guys over?
I like, by the way, before you get into the Jay Moore thing, how we promoted it with promos and liners and all kinds of fun stuff, how we were going to be weighing someone and made a big bit out of it. Sometimes these people are so used to hack radio. Hey, dickbag, you're so used to hack radio.
See, I was just going
to
let it sit there, but go ahead.
No, because it just bugs me that some people are so used to it and accept it that they think everything they're listening to is hack radio. Why can't it just be you look at your friend and call him a fat fuck and say, get on the scale, I want to see what you weigh, you asshole.
Right.
And that, it's not a bit, it's not a fucking, there's no sponsor to it, it's not a thing. See, this show is about kind of hanging out and just doing what we do to our own asshole friends at home. I don't know what you do, douchebag. What was his name?
I forgot his name already.
See, you're forgotten because you're a nobody.
And somebody is thanking us. Oh, yeah. Fast Freddy, thanks for the black baby conclusion, you fucking dick.
Oh, shit. That's right.
Remind me tomorrow, please.
Yeah, like that works.
We had death audio today. We did. That does work. But today we had to like postpone because we had death audio. I mean, you got to have. Really fast. Well, Jay Moore. We talked to Taylor Hicks. I think it was one of Jay Moore's last appearances on our show before he decided that we suck and that it's all about Ron and Fez. with excuses like he's not up at that time and things like that.
Not up at that hour. He's on set. He's doing this. But he gives us a phone call for 5 seconds and then has to run off and shoot something. And then I tune in Ron and Fez. There he is in studio sitting there for hours on end.
Can we pull the audio tomorrow and find it, because it's really a real problem. We're kind of into the American Idol thing and goofing on that. It's getting huge ratings. People are really checking out the show in record numbers. And stupid us, we're like, oh, we want to get some of these contestants on when they get booted. Yeah. Or maybe even some of these awful singers that we've already checked out on TV.
Yeah, it's a, so, sort of a popular show.
So we're like, Roland, Steve, can you call the American Idol people and get that done? And that was when they reminded us that Jay Moore called the publicist for American Idol a cunt.
Do you think she took it the wrong way?
I guess when we were talking to Taylor Hicks.
Yeah.
I got to find the audio. I got to hear it again. It's been a while. Can we get that for tomorrow's show? Someone remind us to play that as well?
I believe what happened was Taylor Hicks was on. We were kind of having fun with him. Was he getting a little, like, he had a go?
He was beyond cool, to be honest with you.
He was really cool.
He was beyond cool.
We heard a publicist in the background.
Kind of like trying to shush him.
Trying to wrap it up because we were being a little blue.
Well, we were being us. Sure.
A little blue.
Sure, we were being us.
And that's when Jay Moore said, you know,
the C word.
They shouldn't, these publicists, she's a cunt, they shouldn't, you know, cut it.
And I rarely ask a favor of the Oney Pest, but we're thinking flowers and lots of flowers. So many flowers that it is obscene.
Never happen.
Why?
Never happened.
Why?
Because it's pest. They send fucking poison sumac.
They could do a nice thing every once in a while.
No, they can't.
So we're not going to ask the pest for help on this one?
It'd be big bouquets of black rubber dildos.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, you're probably right. I was too trusting.
Please put American Idol guests back on the Opie and Anthony show. Thank you, you cunt.
Note to self.
That's what you'd get.
Nope. Pests are there.
Note to self. Never trust the O&A pest.
Exactly. You're trying to beat swords into plowshares.
You're right. You're right.
It's impossible with these people.
You're right. I had a weak moment.
Yeah.
You're right. Screw you. All right. Octane.
Is ready?
Yeah.
There he is. What's up, Octane?
Hey, man.
You're going to play us out today because I really do have to leave. And don't be insulted when in the middle of you playing, you see me walk by you.
Okay.
I really have to go look at houses.
We got one or two you want us to do?
I say two.
Matter to me.
All right, if we're going to do two, we're gonna do your cover this time. We thought it might be appropriate for your show.
What, are you going to start with the cover?
So you can catch it.
All right. Give all the plugs.
All right. Plugs are OctaneRocks.com, MySpace, /OctaneRocks. You can go to iTunes. You can go to CD Baby. You can also check us out tonight at Don Hill's Spring in Greenwich. I got a buddy at home, Jimmy Mills and Wesley Wells, giving them shout-outs, and also Ellis and Mike for coming down here with us today and bringing us down here safe. We appreciate it.
And here's the deal. After the cover, say it's Octane, introduce the other song, plug. You basically got the show till 11 o'clock.
Fantastic.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, from Philly, once again, it's Octane.
Bones are me.
fine. I didn't leave.
Nice.
I'm not leaving in the middle of that.
Hell no.
House of Kings, them bones, of course.
Of course. Why wouldn't you?
Damn, what a great job.
Thank Motherfuckers, now I'm going to be late. All right, I'm leaving this time, really.
All right. This one's up our new record, Rise Up, which you can get on all those places we talked about earlier. The song is called Sad Time. All right, Octane.
Octane, there you go.
Thanks, guys.
Such a sad time, so long without the memories of such a bad time, so far down. I search to find just a small sign of hope to cling to now. Tried so hard, such a long time, fought to work this out. I lost myself, paying no mind, so far down. I finally found just a small sign of hope to cling to now. You take me away, take my whole world, and bring just a bad time for me. Thank you very much, Yo. We want to thank the ONA Show for having us down here today. They told us we have time to do one more, so for all you XM listeners, we want to thank the support, too, we've gotten from all over the place, people checking in our website at OctaneRocks.com, also the MySpace /OctaneRocks. Everybody's been picking up CDs and checking out the iTunes as well. We appreciate it very, very much, man. We appreciate the support. Thank you for checking out local original music. Don't forget tonight, Don Hills, Spring in Greenwich in New York City. If you're in the city, man, come down and say hello. Make sure you say what's up. Tell us, 8:30, we're going on there, so tell us, come say, I heard you on the ONA Show, so we know you're coming from here, man. These guys, much, much respect and love for all the help they've given us thus far, very, very much so. So this one is off our CD, When All Is Said and Done, man. This song is called Pure.
It brought me to that place.
the place I'd run away from so many times before. I tried to break away. You grip my soul like strain as it took away. Radio, thank you guys very, very much. We are the band Octane, born and raised in Philadelphia, PA. Thank you so much for hanging with us in the ONA show.
See you.
Unpredictable, unleashed, unruly,
Anthony,
unwashed, unkempt.
I stink.
Next thing I knew, I had my pants down around my knees and my shirt pulled up to my armpits.
Shut up!
No, who cares?
I can't believe you fell for that again.
Damn you, Hawk.
The Opie and Anthony Show is all about finding creative ways to give people who need money a little extra money. So we came up with the Money Snatch. The Money Snatch is a festive little contest in which young women are invited to the studio, placed in a room chock full of money, and whatever they manage to hold on to, they get to keep. So head on over to opieandanthony.com or foundrymusic.com if you want more information, and try your luck at the Money Snatch.
There is, however, one small catch. One, you have to be totally naked. Two, you ain't carrying that money home in your hand. Three, if it falls out of your cooch before you make it out of the room, you're shit out of luck. Four, no crying. We hate that shit.